Ladies and gentlemen, we direct your attention to the south end zone. The 1996 Wolfpack Marching Band is led onto the field by drum majors Janelle Jacobs and Adam Keith.
Yes.
The band will perform for you a stirring rendition of the Battle Hymn of the Republic, as arranged by Larry Kirchner. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise and join as we proudly present the concert choir, featured soloist Amanda Weiss, performing our national anthem. Thank you. Central High or Central High School by the Inland Sea. These words belong to the alma mater of our great school. Please join the band in the singing of our alma mater. All you Central High fans, on your feet, here's the pep song. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Elmer Engel Stadium. We must announce there will be a 10-minute delay in the start of the game this evening. The officials were caught in a traffic accident out on 75, and then they got caught by the bridge coming into town. So there's going to be a 10-minute delay on the start of this evening's game. So it does give you time to get a little extra coffee or popcorn, or go down and check the booster stand, get a little extra to eat before game time. Welcome this evening, former coaches, athletes, and friends of Elmer Engel. Flint Northern Vikings, coached by Mr. Gary Lee. The Bay City Central Wolves, coached by Mr. Morley Frazier. The officials this evening, the referee will be Paul Elber from Ann Arbor, head linesman Mike Parsons from Ann Arbor, the umpire Bill Suter from Pinckney, the line judge Mike Laird from Redford, and the back judge Derek Dolph of Wald Lake.
Sorry.
Number 32, Adrian Boyd at defensive back. Number 34, Willie McNabb, linebacker. Number 40, Derek Lee, linebacker. Number 51, Eddie Hodo, linebacker. Number 73, Demetrius Solomon, defensive lineman. Number 78, Paulus Campbell, defensive lineman. Number 80, Daryl Richardson, defensive lineman. Number 81, Carlos Gill, defensive lineman. And number 33, Cotrain Woodlake, linebacker. And the starting offensive lineup for your Bay City Central Wolves.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Bay 3 TV and tonight's Sligo Valley League contest.
Marquito.
Flint Northern Vikings visiting Bay City and Central here at Elmer Engel Stadium. Hello, once again, my name is Mike Wisdella, along with Josh Smith. We're going to bring you tonight's exciting ball game between two fine football teams. The Bay City Central Wolves coming in at 4-1. Flint Northern, a dangerous team, coming in at 3-2. And Josh, it will be interesting tonight to see how the Central Wolves rebounded from that tough loss last week against Traverse City Trojans.
That's right. These are both two experienced teams that know what they're doing on the field. And I think they've both proven that with their records so far this year. Bay City only losing the one tough game to Traverse City. And, you know, Flint Northern has really cranked up the heat on the games they've played, too. So it proves to be an exciting matchup here.
Flint Northern comes into the ballgame with a 3-2-loss record. Their wins came against Flint Northwestern, Flint Southwestern, and Saginaw Heritage, and lost to Bay City Western and Saginaw High. Bay City Central's only loss, like we said, came 1 week ago tonight, homecoming night, to the Traverse City Trojans. So they come in with a 4-1 record, and we're just seconds away from tonight's game. Another beautiful night. We've been real lucky, Josh, having outstanding weather. A little bit chillier than last week. No rain in the forecast. Looking for an exciting ball game and a very important ball game for the Central Wolves also.
That's right. We looked for both teams to be very exciting on the field tonight. You're right, it is a little bit nippy out tonight, but that's what, you know, high school sports are all about. It gets cold, and you really have to strap up and hit the guy.
Flint Northern will kick off. Back to receive number 21, Mike Kirchhoff, for the Central Wolves. He'll bring it up the middle, and he is hit extremely hard by Flint Northern, leading the way. Number 3, Jeff Keener, will be 1st and 10 for the Wolves at their own 26-yard line. Once again, the Wolves in their familiar purple and white with the gold helmets. Flint Northern, scarlet and white with the Viking on their helmet. 1st and 10 for the Wolves, just underway here on Elmer Engel Stadium. And also, Josh, Elmer Engel is being honored tonight as they honor the old coach of Bay City Central. Hand off to number 21, Mike Kirchhoff, run right in. Oh, he's tripped up by his own player, number 51 for the Wolves. John Fitzpatrick had a nice block. John fell down blocking, and Mike tripped over his own player, but a nice gain of 4 yards on the play. Well, excuse me, 7 yards on the play, 2nd and 3rd for the Wolves.
That's right. John Fitzpatrick is one of the only sophomores. He plays offensive guard. He's a little bit inexperienced out there, but he does the job well, and he gets out of the hole.
Hand off to Mr. Todd Gall. We've seen him before. Very huge game last week, over 100 yards. And once again, he carries the ball from his fullback position up the middle for a Bay City Central first down. It'll be 1st and 10 for the Wolves at their own 44-yard line.
It looks like, again, Central's going to come out and try and establish Todd Gall's running game right off the bat. You saw him do it last week. They started off passing a little bit more, but they gave the ball to Gall, and he ran with it.
Kevin Fredericks rolls out here to right. Is grabbed by a Flint Northern player. Lucky for Kevin to get the ball away. He was grabbed by number 34, Willie McNabb. Had him by the dogs. He got the pass away incomplete. Second and 10 for the Wolves at their own 44-yard line. 11 minutes and 14 seconds to go. Just underway from Elmer Ingalls Stadium. Saginaw Valley League contest. Flint Northern Vikings and the Bay City Central Wolves. Kevin Fredericks brings the squad up, calling out the signals. Number 7 for the Wolves, Pete Dominowski, split out to right, hand off to number 21, Mike Kirchhoff, shakes and bake, dances a little bit, nice gain on the play, gain of 6 on the play, make it 3rd and 4 for the Wolves.
Looks like Bay City Central is going with the no-huddle offense right now. Kevin Fredericks is a really experienced play caller, and he knows what he's doing out there. He leads the team exceptionally well, and he knows how to move the ball.
3rd down and 5 for the Wolves, right at the 50-yard line. 10:45 and counting in our first quarter. Jay Davis in motion. Fake handoff to Davis. Fredericks rolls out to the left, looking long for number 2. Chris Whitbrook, Dave DeRosier. Great fake by Kevin Fredericks. Took his time, found Dave DeRosier, number 2, way down the field, and a huge pickup for the Wolves of 30 yards. And nice blocking by the offensive line, Josh. Kevin took his time, found his receiver, and put it right on the button.
That's right. That's an excellent play, because in past weeks we've seen Fredericks try and rush, throw across his body, not set his feet properly. So that was a really well-executed play. He stopped. He looked and saw Dave DeRosier down the field, and he just dotted him right in the chest. So
first and 10. Sorry, Josh.
No,
first and 10 for the Wolves at the Flint Northern 21. Hand off to Todd Gall up the middle. He rumbling down to the inside the 5-yard line. Going to be close to a first down for Bay City Central. And it looks like the Central Wolves are going to ride that horse again this week. Todd Gall, big game last week, over 100 yards. And he's starting right off where he left last week, Josh.
That's right. He's a primetime player. These guys are just now starting to get into shape a little bit better after about the 5th week of play. And they're really motoring, especially Todd Gall. Mike Kirchhoff's been getting slow out of the gate a little bit, but he doesn't have much blocking when he gets the ball.
First and goal, the goal for the Wolves on the Flint Northern 6-yard line. Hand off to, again, to number 40, Todd Gall. He rumbles up to the middle. No single on a touchdown yet. Close to the touchdown, but he's inside the 1-yard line. Going to be second and goal for the Wolves at the 1-yard line. 9 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the first quarter. Bay City Central knocking on the door right off the bat.
That's right. They have 9.5 minutes left to go, and they're really trying to score right off the bat here to get the game moving, get the momentum in their favor, and it looks like it'll be an exciting ball game.
Kevin Fredericks barks up the signal. He goes in the touchdown, Bay City Central, quarterback 3, number 12, Kevin Fredericks, for the very first touchdown of tonight's game, making the score, Bay City Central 6, Northern Vikings nothing, and a very impressive drive of probably 75 yards for the Wolves. A little mix up on the run, a little mix up on the pass. Outstanding effort to start the game, and Coach Frazier's got to be extremely happy the way Bay City Central moved down the field, Josh.
That's right. Bay City Central leads the league right now. They have, in total yardage, 1,788 yards. They're doing really extremely well on the offensive side of the ball, and teams are having trouble stopping them. Even Flint Northern plays consistent ball in the Valley League. So Central is really moving the ball, and they look to have an exciting ball game here in their hands.
Excellent drive for the Central Wolves. They went 70 yards, excuse me, and they took the ball right down the field with a nice mix up of runs, nice mix of pass. So Coach Frazier has a nice game plan for the first 15 to 20 plays of the ball game. Mixed it up a little bit. Central will kick off from our left to our right, number 34, Brent Vrabel, to kick deep. Deep for the Northern Vikings, number 20 for the Vikings. His name is Jamal Lattimore. Also back, number 82. Excuse me. You can't see his number, Josh. Can you see his number from here?
No, I'm not sure.
Standing to the side, we can't see his number, but the Wolves will kick off to the Vikings. 7-0, basically Central lead. 9:21 in the first quarter to go. Excellent drive to start the game off. Braveball, short end-over-end kick. Picked up by the Viking player, number 1, Mike Childress, he takes them back about a 5-yard gain. Be first and 10 for the Northern Vikings at their own 33-yard line.
Like I said, during the beginning of the season, a lot of the players are kind of getting back, you know, working the rust out of their system over the summer and whatnot. And Kevin Fredericks came out right away. I'm really excited about this central offense because they came out right away and they punched it right to Flint Northern. And Flint Northern is in the hole now, and they have 9 minutes and 20 seconds to come back on central. But it really does a lot when a team goes up the first drive of the game.
Flint Northern, first and 10 at their own 37. High backfield, double split out to the right, split out to the left. Pro style offense. And hand off by number 9, the quarterback, Nicholas Sparks. He hands off to number 6, Ida Beard. That's their workhorse. Number 6, Ida Beard, had a big game last year down at Flint at Atwood Stadium. He had close to 300 yards rushing, so he's their workhorse. A gain of 4 on the play, call it 5. Be second and 5 for the Flint Northern Vikings at their own 41-yard line.
That's right. It looks like Flint Northern is going to move the ball consistently as well. That first play shows me a lot in a football game, and they look to be coming out of the gate here.
Sparks barking out the signals. Long count by the Northern Viking quarterback. Hand off to Beard again. Off left guard. He's met immediately by number 20, Jay Davis. Also went on to play number 52, Eric Swinehart. Stepping up, 3rd and 3 at their own 44-yard line. Nice job on defense.
That's right. The defense really is stepping up, it looks like. And like I said, this really figures to be an exciting ball game. I'm really looking forward to seeing how this one goes down the stretch because Central came right off the bat and scored. And Flint Northern is moving the ball well, even though Central's defense is stepping up.
Split out to the right, Jeff Keener. Split out to the left, Nicholas Sparks. Number 6, Ida Beard. He hands off the pitch from number 9, Sparks. He goes across to the right side of the line. He's close to a first down. Official timeout on the field. I think they'll take a measurement. He looks awful close from here, Josh, but they're going to take a timeout and bring the chains in. 7 minutes, 57 seconds to go, and it looks like they're going to ride Ida Beard, number 6, the 5'10", 185-pound senior from Flint Northern, running back, defensive back. Typical Flint Northern team, good size and a lot of speed.
That's right, and their blockers really are moving. They're really helping the running back, Ida Beard, out because they get outside and they move around a lot. They're a really experienced line. They're moving across the line and getting to the defensive lineman very well. They're opening up holes for Ida Beard, and they're only gaining 3 or 4 yards on a carry, but that's enough for a first down right here. And as they're about to cross midfield, that's very nice to be proving your offensive line in the first part of the game.
7:57 to go in the first quarter. First and 10 for the Vikings at their own 48-yard line. Official timeout on the field. The referee will come over and talk to the head coach of Bay City Central, Morley Frazier. We had a 10-minute delay tonight because of the, according to our sources, the referees were involved in a small car accident and also hit a boat here in Bay City. So we had about a 10 to 12 minute delay. It looks like what's happening is there might be some headphone problems. If one sideline doesn't have them, the other sideline can't have them. So we'll see what's going on, but they straighten it all out. We're going to play football.
I think it'll prove to be a big advantage if one sideline had the headphones and the other didn't. So, yeah, that might be a concern. The referees getting in that car accident, being held up by the bridge, goes along with your bee sting there, Mike.
I got stung on the bee tonight, so it's the epitome of the night.
That's right.
I thought I killed that bee once, but he came back to get me, but I got him the second time. So, first and 10 for the Vikings at their own 48-yard line. Back to pass, number 9, Sparks on a fade. The number 85 for the Northern Vikings, or number 89, Nelson Lakey. Incomplete. What a pass. Nice job. He threw that ball about 30, 40 yards in the air on the fade. Number 85, Stocker, the wide receiver, incomplete for the Vikings, making second and 10.
That's right. Stephen Stocker had a step on his man there. I think Brad Cox was trying to cover, and he really got juked Cox very well and got out of the gate. So that throw was just a little bit long for him, but he would have had a nice pickup there if he could have stretched out and caught that.
First and 10, or second and 10 for the Vikings on their own 48-yard line. Split out to the right, wide left also for the Vikings. Sparks breaking out the signals. Taking a long time on a quickie in. Nice job by number 40 for the Vikings. Derek Lee, a nice pass. He put it right where he could only put it. And a nice pickup by the Vikings of 7 yards. We'll call it third down and three for the Vikings at the Bay City Central 45-yard line.
That's a very important play when you come out and your first two plays on a little on a down first down situation or passes, you have to hit one of those two routes. You're going to be third down and still long 10. So that was a very important play. They got their 7 yards and now they're third and short.
Third and three for the Vikings at the Central 45-yard line. Central looking to step up on D. Hand off to Ida Beard, and he is stuffed after no gain and probably a loss on the play. In on the play, number 34, Brable also there, 43, Jones. And there's that number 33, Jared Ratluski, who had an outstanding game last year. And if I'm not mistaken, I think Brad Jones was the Gold Helmet Player of the Week for the Bay City Times, if I'm not mistaken. I just looked at it briefly. But what an honor for that young man. Flint Northern decides to punt, fourth and four from the Central 44. Back to receive the punt, number one, Chris Whitrow. A big defensive play for the Wolves, stopping the Vikings on third and short. Whitrow, nice punt. Takes his own, he's got slips and falls down inside their own 10-yard line. Josh, he had some running room. If he wouldn't have slipped, he had some real estate out in front of him.
That's right, that was a nice little punt. It was not a line drive, but it was right to him, and he had a little bit of running room right there. He could have moved the ball up a little bit, but they start out on about their own 8-9-yard line. And this could be tough for Central, but it also could help them eat the clock up a little bit in the first quarter here with 6 1/4 to go.
First and 10 for the Wolves at their own 8-yard line. Split out to the right, number 42, Craig Suwadowski. Out to the left, number 4, Adam Mallory. Kevin Frederick's quarterback, Gall the fullback. Kirchhoff, the running back, hand off to Todd Gall, following his blocker. Gain of about 1 yard on the play. Second down and 9 for the Wolves at their own 9-yard line. Well, we'll call it 2 yards. Second and 10, second and 8, gain of 2 for the Wolves. And looks like they're going to try to ride Todd Gall again after a big game last week. They're going to try to give him the ball and pound it up the middle again, Josh.
That's right. The Central coaches, Morley Frazier in particular, is very persistent. He likes to give the ball back to Gall as many times as he can, and he'll mix it up a little bit with Kirchhoff and Fredericks and get the pass off a little bit too.
Hand off to number 40, Todd Gall, off the right side of the line. He gains about 3 on the play, brought down by number 40 for the Northern Vikings, Derek Lee. Third down and 5 yards to go for the Wolves at their own 14-yard line. 5:20 to go in the first quarter. Bay City Central 7, Flint Northern nothing. Good evening once again. My name is Mike Wisdella, along with Josh Smith. Josh, you did a nice job singing the national anthem with the choir. I didn't know you had that talent in you. Did a nice job. Sounded excellent tonight.
Thanks. I was worried about getting up here in time, but we made it and then started off the game pretty well.
Thanks to the referees being late. Kevin Fredericks dropped back the pass. Gets a little pressure on. Oh, almost intercepted by number 40, Derek Lee. Hit him right in the numbers, and thank goodness he dropped him, because if he would have caught that, that would have been 6 for Northern. That makes it 4th and 5 for the Wolves at their own 14. Brings on a punting situation. Back to receive the punt for the Vikings, number 32, Adrian Boyd, and number 15, Leon Hall. Kevin Frederick punts the ball. Nice spiral out to the left side. Did not catch a fair catch. Didn't get a fair catch. Penalty on the play. The ball is recovered by number 4, Adam Mallory. But there is a penalty on the play, Josh, and I don't think he gave him enough room to catch the ball.
That's right. Dan Maciejewski, I think, moved in too quickly a little bit, and he bowled the man over and didn't allow him space to catch the ball. So that's probably what the penalty is. I think Central backed up in their own zone like that. That was a really costly incompletion. Maybe if they could have been a little more conservative and moved the ball up for a first down, because this gives Flint Northern very, very good field position, and they're inside Central's half of the field, and they don't even have to work for it. So now they can move the ball down and try and punch it in right away with 4:42 left in the first quarter.
Referees still talking about the play. They're going to talk some more. They're going to bring in both captains. They're going to talk to the Flint Northern captain. They're going to talk in number 17 for the Wolves, Leiterman. They're going to have a little discussion. We got pushing against the Wolves, clipping against the Vikings, offsetting penalties. They're still talking about it. I don't have my referee book with me, Josh, so I don't know really what's going to come of this, but we'll straighten it out, and we'll see what happens. Once again, it's 7-0, 4 minutes, 42 seconds to go in the first quarter here at Elmer Engel Stadium on Elmer Engel Night here at Bay City Central. They're honoring the old football coach, a legend around these parts, who had a couple or three mythical state championships and won a ton of football games. Many of his old players and friends and family members are here honoring Coach Engel. So it's once again, another big weekend here at Bay City Central.
He was an extraordinary football coach. He won a lot of football games for this school, and he was a big role model for a lot of coaches around the city and around the state, frankly. He was an excellent, excellent football coach, and he did a lot for the city.
Fredericks back to punt again. We'll do it all over. Another nice punt by Kevin. Takes the Bay City bounce. And number four, Adam Ellery, downs it at the Bay City Central 46-yard line. First and 10 for the Vikings at the Central 46-yard line. And 7-0 for the Wolves. Northern doing a nice job by running the ball, mixing up the plays. They got great field position now. Let's see if the coaches from Flint Northern can stick it in the end zone and if Bay City Central can step up to the challenge on their defense.
That's right. Flint Northern's moving the ball consistently, and they're only getting 3 or 4 yards a carry, but that's all you need to win a football game.
Sparks barking out the signals. Hands off the beard up the middle. Tackled immediately by number 78 for the Wolves, Patrick Malley. If I'm not mistaken, Patrick is in the choir too, wasn't he? Came out there and sang in his football uniform.
That's right. He made it out a little bit late. You know, football warm-ups take precedence over the choir singing. But, you know, he tried to make it as best he could, just like I did up here. So.
Well, if he didn't have to have that for a grade, I hope he didn't. He was a little bit tardy, so we'll put him tardy on the report card. Gain of 4 on the play for the Vikings. 2nd and 6 from the Bay City Central 41-yard line. Sparks, the quarterback, barking out the signals. Beard, the tailback, barking out the signals. Fake handoff on another fade to number 40 for the Vikings. Derek Lee, touchdown, Northern Vikings on the coverage. Number 1, Chris Whipple. Excellent pass by number 9, Sparks. He could only put it one place, Josh. He put it exactly where he had to. Lee, great concentration, catching the ball. Chris Whipple right on him, but it was just an outstanding pass and an outstanding catch.
That's right. Chris was trying not to pick up the pass interference on that play, and Lee did a really good job of grabbing that ball and concentrating on it and getting to the end zone. He picked it off Chris Whipple's shoulder, and he moved the ball right into the end zone. So that's what Flint Northern is looking for, a long pass play. It puts them right back in the ball game. This extra point will make it tied up. A little bit longer to go in the first quarter, but it's really back and forth football. They're really moving the ball consistently, each team, and they're stepping up on defense too.
Typical Saginaw Valley League game, back and forth action. The extra point kick is up. The extra point is good. Kicking the ball with number 89, Nelson Lakey. So that ties the ball game. 3 minutes, 49 seconds to go in the first quarter. Bay City Central 7, Flint Northern 7. And talking to Coach Frazier earlier in the week, I asked him how the kids were responding after the tough loss last week. And as usual, he said kids were doing an outstanding job in practice. Got to put that game behind them and concentrate on Flint Northern. And seems like Bay City Central came out ready to play tonight, Josh.
That's right. Phil Zanotti really pushed to get that Traverse City game on the schedule for Bay City Central this year. And Bay City Central did not come out and disappoint him or Morley Frazier or Gene Rademacher or any of the coaches. They really came out and played a hard football game. They lost in the closing minutes, but it was an excellent, excellent football game, and they had nothing to be ashamed of. This Flint Northern team offers another challenge, but they're stepping up. Both teams are stepping up, and it figures to be a nice little game going down the home stretch.
Big challenge again tonight for Bay City Central. No puppies on this schedule for the Wolves. Lakey to kick off. To receive the kick, number 21, Mike Kirchhoff. He's up to the 20, the 25. He comes out here to the right, and he's caught. Slowed up by number 80 for the Vikings. Diario Richardson tripped up immediately after that by number two, Isaac Crawford. Be first and 10 for the Wolves at their own 27-yard line. And you can see that the Northern Vikings, Josh, have quite a bit of speed on that team.
That's right. They're coming out to smack, and they can move to get there. So it looks like Flint Northern stepping up a little bit, too. They put Central back down here on their own 25-yard line, and they have to move the ball up if they want to score.
Official timeout on the field. Dan Maciejewski split out to the left for the Wolves. In the slot, number 42, Craig Suwadowski. In the backfield, number 17, Leiterman, the fullback, and number 21, Mike Kirchhoff. Kevin Fredericks, the central quarterback, hands off to Mike Kirchhoff around the right end. Stuffed immediately by a host of Northern Vikings. Number 51 for the Vikings, Eddie Hodo, in on the tackle. A loss of a yard on the play. Second down and 11 for the Wolves at their own 26-yard line. Outstanding defense by the Vikings. They strung that play out, and Kirchhoff had no place to go.
That's right. Like I said, both teams are stepping up, as, especially Flint Northern right now on defense. They came out on the kickoff and really creamed Mike Kirchhoff, and now they're coming out to get him again. Looks like they're going to step up in the challenge for the first-ranked offense in the Valley.
Kevin Fredericks rolls out to his left. Throws a nice bullet to number 42, Craig Suwadowski. He had to go down, like sliding in the home plate. Excellent job by Suwadowski, concentrating on the ball, catching the ball. First and 10 for the Wolves at their own 45-yard line. And it looks like Kevin Fredericks once again is on his game tonight, Josh.
That's right. So are the coaches. They're mixing the game up a little bit. And like I said, Fredericks will come out consistently, throw the ball, and run it when he has to. And the coaches are giving that to him. They're letting him throw. And Gall is getting a lot of good carries, too. So Central's offense is not a bunch of slouches either.
Hand off to number 20, Mike Kirchhoff. Nice dance across to the right, left side of the line. Tries to cut back. Number 34, Willie McNabb with a shoestring tackle. Willie wouldn't have got him, Josh. He was going for some big yardage.
That's right. You usually don't see Mike Kirchhoff up the middle like that. But when he goes up the middle, all he needs is one little break, and he can speed out to the end zone. So he almost broke that. You're right. And Central's offense is going to be very explosive going down the home stretch.
Second down and 7 for the Wolves at their own 47-yard line. Into the game, number 20, Jay Davis. And number 7, Dominowski. Kevin Fredericks hands off to number 21. Mike Kirchhoff cuts back inside and is met immediately by number 51, Eddie Hodo, from his linebacker position. No gain on the play. Third and a long 7 for the Wolves. Minute 49 and counting in the first quarter. One thing I did notice, Josh, is that Leiterman is playing fullback, and I don't see Todd Gall in the ball game, or I don't see him on the sidelines. I don't know if he's hurt or not feeling well, but hasn't played the last 3 or 4 downs, so maybe we can find out what's going on with Mr. Gall. Anyway, it's 3rd and 7 for the Wolves at their own 47-yard line. Back to pass. Kevin Fredericks, flag on the play. Rifles one to number 9, Jeff Frazier, in a big pop on the play by number 34, Willie McNabb, an outstanding linebacker, all the way down to the northern 35-yard line. But the preliminary call is holding against Bay City Central. That'll move him back 15 yards. And Kevin Fredericks on his game. But the offensive line got caught holding, so they'll bring it back.
That's right. He threw a frozen rope to Jeff Frazier, number 9, and you'd really hate to see a holding penalty bring that back, because that's a big third down. Central can pick it up, and they move the ball across midfield. You hate to bring that back in a penalty, and with just over a minute left in the first quarter, you'd like to see them move the ball up before the second quarter hits.
That turned out to be about a 25-30-yard penalty, spot foul. So they move back all the way back to their own 37-yard line. It's going to be third down and a long 17 yards for the Wolves. Split out to the right, number 1, Chris Whitbrow, who's having an outstanding year for Central. Out to the left, number 9, Jeff Frazier. Look for a pass here. Kevin Fredericks almost fumbled the ball, but hand off to number 17, Leiterman. He rumbles in second effort. He's close to first down, and I think he made it, Josh.
I think he did, too. That's a gutsy call by the Central coaches there. They Northern came out in a prevent defense and with only a three-man front, and Central knew they were going to do that. They let Leiterman have the ball. Gall, you'd think if Gall wasn't in the game, they wouldn't give it to the fullback, but Leiterman really shows he can carry the load, and he picks up the first down on a really tough play that he might was really gutsy, and they're moving the ball across midfield.
First and 10 for the Wolves at the Northern 45-yard line. Gutsy call by Coach Frazier. Timeout on the field, Flint Northern. Gutsy call by Morley Frazier. I was expecting the pass. He had me fooled, and he went to the run with Chad Leiterman in for a goal. Probably the last person that Northern expected to carry the ball was Leiterman. So first and 10 for the Wolves at the Northern 45-yard line with 48 seconds to go in the first half. Central 7, Northern 7.
That's right. As the Flint Northern coaches could probably use their tactics. You know, their mindset is that Todd Gall is out of the game after looking at game film of him and Mike Kirchhoff. Todd Gall's out of the game, and you see Chad Leiterman, who's never really carried the ball that much for Central, in the backfield. And they didn't think that Central would give him the ball on a third and very long. That was extremely long after the penalty. So Central's coaches really counteracted the Flint Northern's thinking on that with a three-man front, and they came out in the run. And that's a really, really gutsy call on a third and very long.
Once again, some more outstanding camera work by our camera people. Hope you're enjoying tonight's Saginaw Valley League contest here from Ingalls Stadium. I'm Mike Lisdell along with Josh Smith. 7-7 ball game to go, 48 seconds in the first quarter. Kevin Fredericks takes the handoff to Kirchhoff, rolls around left side, and they've got that play down pat tonight, Josh. Kevin's rolling out both left and right, dragging number 5, Brad Ackley, across the middle. And I'll tell you what, Kevin Fredericks is on fire tonight. He is in what they say a groove.
That's right. He's really got his rhythm going. He's hit Brad Ackley and Jeff Frazier both consistently so far. He's not throwing the ball on target like we saw last week. He lets the ball float when he doesn't set his feet properly. And he's really got his mechanics working for him tonight. He must have practiced this last week.
Coaches probably noticed a couple things wrong, and they worked on it. They did a good job. Hand off to number 17, Leiterman again. What a nice surprise for Coach Frazier having Leiterman in the game. Gall has not played in a while. We don't know if he's hurt or where he's at. There he's on, down on the sideline. Trainer Janet Clyde is doing some, giving him some medical attention right now, maybe an ankle. But Leiterman, what a nice surprise. Gain of 5 on the play, 2nd and 5, and Coach Frazier has to be extremely happy that Chad Leiterman can come in and fill the shoes of Todd Gall and not miss a beat.
That's right. You kind of expect your second string players to be able to come in and kind of hold a little bit of water, but Chad Leiterman is really mirroring Gall, actually, in his first few carries. He moved the ball for that little over 30 yards there on that first carry, and on this carry he picks up a good 6 yards. He's carried people on his back already, just like Gall has, and they're not missing a step with Leiterman in the game. So that proves to be a really good advantage with Central if they can put their second and third string players in and not miss a beat.
Todd Gall is the 4th leading rusher in the Valley. He has a total of 586 yards and 94 attempts for a nice 6.23 average, and also has 7 touchdowns. So he's been carrying the ball a lot this year for the Central Wolves. Great per carry average of over 6 yards. And to bring in Leiterman and not lose a beat, that's a nice plus for Coach Frazier.
That's right. That's a big advantage. Like I said, when you can bring in other people and you don't lose anything on your squad, that's a really good plus, because you don't have to worry about what people are in the game so much. If everyone does their job consistently, they've used both Jay Davis and Craig Suwadowski at the wing position. Now they're using Leiterman and Gall both at fullback. It proves to be very nice for the Central Wolves.
2nd and 4 for the Wolves at their own 26-yard line. Hand off to Leiterman. Kevin Fredericks just barely got it to him. He was caught in the backfield by number 16, Juwan Deloach. He did get the ball to him. Gain of about 3 on the play. 3rd and a short, 1 yard for the Wolves at the Northern 22-yard line. Just started the 22. Second quarter here at Elmer Ingalls Stadium. Central 7, Northern 7 in a Saginaw Valley League game between two fine football teams, and both consider this game very important in the playoff rankings. Out to the left, number 4, Adam Mallory. Hand out to number 21, number 17, Leiterman again. He gets the first down for the Wolves. It'll be first and 10 for the Wolves at the northern 20-yard line.
That's right. Number 16, Jamon Deloach, is for the Vikings, is lining up at nose tackle, and he's a very small wide receiver and defensive back. So I think the northern Vikings are certain that they can move around on Central's interior line, and they're doing a good job of getting to Kevin Frederick's feet and fumbling up plays.
First and 10 for the Wolves. Hand off to number 17, Leiterman. Breaks one tackle, tries to get through another one, but a nice pickup for number 17, Leiterman. He gained 9 yards on the play, all the way down to the northern 11-yard line. And Chad Leiterman is taking the place of Todd Gall, but here comes Todd Gall back in the ballgame after an absence. You can see that his right ankle is taped. Looks like he did have a small injury, but he's going to give it a try. But a nice job by number 17, Chad Leiterman, and the Bay City Central faithful let him know about what a nice job he did.
That's right. The people here know what he does for the team, and you can't do much from the sideline with an ankle injury. Kevin Fredericks came up limping on that first play of the game there, so you have to wonder about the stars of the Central team.
Penalty on the play, delay of game by the Wolves. Coach Morley Frazier is a little bit upset with his offensive squad. Unnecessary penalty. There was second and one. Now that's going to be second and seven, second and six for the Wolves at the 16-yard line. Not the type of penalty you want down that close when you're that close to first down, Josh. So they're going to redo it. It'll be second down and seven for the Wolves at the northern 17-yard line. 10 minutes, 11 to go in the second quarter. Out to the left, number one, Chris Whitbroke. Kevin Fredericks barks out the signal for the Wolves. He drops back on a quickie in. Oh, intercepted by number 15 for the Vikings. Leon Hall and Kevin Fredericks drop back in a one-step drop back. Threw it a little high to number one, Chris Whitbroke, right into the hands of number 15, Leon Hall. Be first and 10 for the Wolves, or for the Vikings, at your own 20-yard line. And who knows what would happen if that penalty wouldn't have came there, Josh?
That's right. Kevin Fredericks was being very consistent in the first part of the game, but that ball was badly misplaced, and it was thrown right into the arms of the Central, or the Flint Northern players. So Kevin Fredericks, I think, is having trouble with the grubbers, and he needs to set his feet and just relax in the pocket.
First and 10 for the Vikings at their own 20-yard line. 7-7 tie between the Vikings and the Wolves. Hand off to number 6, Ida Beard. He's met immediately. Number 17, Chad Leiterman. What a huge defensive play. A big loss for the Vikings all the way back to their own 14-yard line. But Leiterman, he's doing it on offense. And now he steps up with a big defensive play for the Wolves. Loss of 5 yards on the play. Second and 15 for the Vikings at their own 14-yard line.
That's right. Chad Leiterman's lining up at strong linebacker on the right side over there. And he compliments Jared Radlewski very well. Jared Radlewski likes to run around and create some havoc, and Chad Leiterman's getting into it too. So looks like both the outside linebackers for Central are getting into the game.
Coach Rademacher's defense stepping up big, sending the Northern Vikings in the wrong direction. Sparks the quarterback, long signal count again. Drops back the pass on another fade route. He's got the receiver out there for Northern, incomplete to the Northern Viking. Number 89, Nelson Lakey. Hawthorne, the intended receiver, covered out there by number 13, Cox. But Sparks has got a nice arm. He can put the ball out there quite a ways.
That's right. And the Northern Vikings wide receivers are getting a step on the Central D-backs. So the passing game, Northern might step up a little bit if the quarterback can just throw the ball a little bit more sharply on the dot, and they might have a nice pickup here with one of these wide receivers.
Third and long, 15 for the Vikings at their own 15-yard line. Central defense, time to step up. Oh, almost caught in the backfield. Hand off for the pitch to number 6, Beard, and he is met by number 43, Brad Jones. After no gain, he ran a lot west to east, but he didn't go north and south. No gain on the play. In fact, he lost a half yard. Be fourth and 16 for the Vikings. They are in a punting position. back to receive the kickoff, number one, Chris Whitlow, and number 21, Mike Kirchhoff. And once again, Gene Rademacher, defensive coordinator, his defensive squad picks up, and Bay City Central is going to get excellent field position out of this, Josh.
That's right. They sent Brad Jones on the blitz that time, and he really had Ida Beer in the backfield for a big loss.
Central was setting up for return. The punter for the Vikings dropped the ball, number 89, Lakey. He dropped the ball. The ball stays inside Northern territory. It is down at the Northern 42-yard line. First and 10 for the Bay City Central Wolves at the Northern 42-yard line. Something that Central has to take advantage of right here, Josh's outstanding field position. Forget about that intercepted pass and try to get a nice touchdown, nice drive here. 8:45 to go in the first half.
That's right. Central's got to set up and score here. With 8:45 left to go in the half, they got to get some more momentum back. They got to get the score in their favor.
Number 40, Todd Goldenbach here. He rumbles and bumbles and stumbles all the way down inside the 30-yard line. First and 10 for the Wolves. Nice run by Gall. Doesn't look like that ankle's giving him much trouble. He's hobbling around a little bit. But with a nice pickup and a first down, I'm sure that ankle feels a lot better now after that nice run.
That's right, and Todd Gall has never been one to sit the bench for an injury. He's consistently been in Central's backfield, and he's one of the guys they can depend on. He's very durable, and he'll move the ball even if he's having a heart attack.
Hand off to number 21, Mike Kirchhoff, and a nice cutback. Excellent run by number 21, Kirchhoff, on the cutback. Off the right side of the offensive line, outstanding blocking. Number two, Isaac Crawford on the tackle, but not before the Central Wolves picked up a first down just on the outside the 15-yard line. The Northern will be first and 10 for the Wolves, and two back-to-back first down big running plays for the Wolves.
That's right. You'd like to see Mike Kirchhoff get back into the action a little bit. He's been consistently stopped by the teams he's played in these last weeks because they look at film a lot. And they have to give the ball back to Gall instead of Kirchhoff.
Hand off to number 40, Gall, straight up the middle, and he rumbles for a gain of about 6 yards, probably seven, Josh, and it's second down and three. And Central right now is picking up their running game. Into the game, number 17, Leiterman, and number 7, Pete Dominowski. Coming out, number 4, Ellery, and number 21, Mike Kirchhoff. But Central is establishing a good running game down inside Northern territory.
That's right, and it comes from Flint Northern having to punt down deep in their own territory. They got very good field position. They don't have to worry about backing up at all. They can just rear head and fire at the Flint Northern defensive squad, and they're moving the ball consistently, especially on the ground.
Good point, Josh. Special teams always playing a key role in these high school football games. Good field position to start this drive. They started it on the 46-yard line. They've had back-to-back first downs. Now it's second down and three for the Wolves on the Northern 8-yard line. Once again, Central knocking on the door. Second and two for the Wolves at the Northern 8-yard line. Dominowski's put out to left. Hand off to number 40, Todd Gall. And he had a huge hole off the right guard. Looks like he did get the first down. It's going to be first and goal for the Wolves inside the 5-yard line. I think I can see it up here, Josh. They're going to call it first down. First and goal for the Wolves at just inside the 5-yard line. We'll mark it at the 5. Hopefully Central right here can put the touchdown in. And a nice drive by the Wolves.
That's right, and a nice drive by Todd Gall. Again, he's being very consistent, even with the ankle injury. Janet Clyde taped him up, and he's moving the ball. He'll probably get a touchdown right here.
First and goal for the Wolves at the Northern 5-yard line. Hand off to Gall. He scoots up the middle for a short gain of about 1 yard. We'll say first and goal, second and goal to go at the 4-yard line. Bay City Central knocking on the door, 6 minutes. 44 seconds to go and counting in the first half. Bay City Central 7 and the Flint Northern Vikings 7. Saginaw Valley League contest, very important game for the Central Wolves to stay in the playoff rankings. We'll talk to you a little bit later where the updated playoff rankings are. Second and goal for the Wolves at the Northern 4-yard line. handoff, fake handoff to number 21, Kirchhoff. Fredericks rolls around, trying to get outside. Penalty flag on the play. Kevin is taken out of bounds at the 1 yard line, but there is a penalty on the play. And I got a bad feeling in my gizzard, Josh, that this might go against the Bay City Central Wolves on a clipping penalty.
That's right. When they bring the ball down inside the 10 and 5 yard line, they have to be very consistent and move the ball up. I thought Todd Gall might get a few more carries and they'd try and punch it in for his 8th touchdown. But they faked to him and Fredericks tried to roll out, maybe get a pass off, but he ended up running it. And it might be very costly. It could be a 3rd down or it could be even worse as a penalty. You have to pay attention to what the score is going into halftime. You have to pay attention to whose momentum is going. Central like to get up in the score to go into the second half. They'd like to get up on the Flint Northern Vikings and take them down the home stretch with the lead.
As you can see, a little bit of concern on the face of Coach Frazier. Both times the last two drives, Central's been in the red zone. One time they had an interception. Now they had a big penalty of 15 yards. Second down and goal to goal. 18 yards, hand off the goal. Up the middle, and he gets all of it back inside the 5 yard line. Todd Gall, the workhorse for the Bay City Central Wolves on this play, he rambles all the way down inside the 5 yard line. The 3rd and goal for the Wolves at the Northern 4 yard line. Excellent call by Coach Frazier. Knocking on the door once again. 3rd and goal for the Wolves at the Northern 4 yard line. Split out to the left, number 1, Chris Whiprow. Kevin Fredericks barking out the signals for the Wolves. Hands out to number 40, Todd Gall. He's caught from behind by number 6, Beard. And there was a big hole there, Josh, but I think Todd slowed down a little bit with the bad ankle. A healthy Todd Gall probably would have made that a touchdown.
That's right. Not many people can catch Gall from behind. When he gets out of the hole, he can really move. And they got the ball down. Now they make it pretty much an extra point position right there in the 3-yard line. It's a 4th down, so it looks like they're going to go for a field goal.
Coach Frazier decides to go for 3. Kevin Frederick's been excellent all year, kicking extra points and kicking field goals. Great camera shot from the Central Gymnasium. Looks like the ball is going to come right up. Then the kick is blocked. Picked up by number 16 for the Vikings. And that's Juwan Deloach. And the kick is blocked, so the Wolves get in the red zone twice and come away empty-handed. And a nice block by the Northern Vikings. So that'll make it 1st and 10 for the Vikings at their own 11-yard line. It's got to be very frustrating right now for Coach Frazier and his football team. 2 times inside the red zone, Josh, and didn't come away with a field goal or any points on either drive.
That's right. I talked about that a little bit earlier in the season. Central can get down in the 20-yard line and just consistently have breaks go towards the other team. And that was another one. Kevin Fredericks possibly would have made that to be 3 points. They would have liked to have 7. They were right down there in the 5-yard line. But they came up empty-handed twice in a row. Flint Northern's really stepping up on defense.
Great camera work on that extra point from the top of Central Gymnasium. Sparks rolls out to his left. He's caught. The ball is up. And, almost intercepted by number 1, Chris Whiprow. Ball intended for number 40, Derek Lee. And Sparks, the Northern quarterback, had a whole bunch of people nipping at his ankles and feet. Got the ball away, underthrew his man. Chris Whiprow almost had an interception, and that would have been a huge turnover in Northern Territory. He had a lot of real estate if he could have caught that ball. 2nd and 10 for the Vikings at their own 11-yard line.
That's right. Nick Sparks had purple and white hanging all over him on that one. If he would have had a little bit better feet, gotten away from the central defenders there behind his own line of scrimmage, that ball would have been a lot better thrown, and it might have been 6 points for the Flint Northern Vikings.
2nd and 10 for the Vikings at their own 11-yard line, deep in their own territory. Central's going to step up on the defense here. Hopefully they'll get a big stop, and there is a penalty on the play. Preliminary call, delay of game, going to move Northern back 5 yards. 2nd and 15 for the Vikings at their own 6-yard line, and here's a great opportunity for the Bay City Central Wolves to take advantage of the Northern mistakes down deep in their own territory.
That's right. Northern can't afford to make these mistakes down in their own territory. They get moved back to their own 5-yard line. And you don't have much room to sit back and pass. They'd like to pass out of that hole. And you can do that from the 10-yard line, but a 3-step drop will bring you into the end zone, and they don't want to cost a safety.
Second and 15 for the Vikings at their own 6-yard line. Sparks, once again, taking a long time to get the snap. He's looking over here to the right sideline. Good defense by number 13, Cox. Number 3, the receiver, attending receiver, Jeff Keener. But Brad Cox with an outstanding defensive job out of his defensive backfield position, playing man-to-man against Keener. And the Sparks overthrew the intended receiver, Keener. 3rd and 15 for the Vikings, deep in their own territory. Coach Gene Rademacher calling out the signals for his defensive squad. Along there's the brain trust of the Bay City Central Wolves. Coach Frazier, Coach Zanotti, Coach Rademacher. Big play here for the Central Wolves. 3rd and long for the Vikings on their own 6-yard line.
That's right. The Flint Northern Vikings move back in their own field here. And they, like I said, a 3-step drop brings them back close to their own end zone. And if they were on their 10-yard line, they would have been able to drop back and throw that pass a little bit better. But now they have to bring in the punt squad and get rid of it. And this gives Central a very good field position again, going back into halftime with just over 4 minutes left. Last time Central got the ball this deep in Northern Territory, they couldn't capitalize. So I think they're going to be a lot more scoring-minded on this drive.
Gain of only 2 on the play. 4th and 13 for the Vikings at their own 7-yard line. Back to punt number 89, Lakey. Little bit of pressure on the play. Mike Kirchhoff back for the Wolves. He cuts to the right. He's met immediately on a nice tackle by number 1, Mike Childress. But Josh, we do have a penalty on the play. Preliminary indication by our referee. Roughing the kicker, going to make it 1st and 10 for the Vikings. And a huge mistake for the Bay City Central Wolves. They would have had great field position at the northern 37-yard line. Instead, the defensive team's going to come out 1st and 10 for the Vikings, still in their own territory, but they still have the ball. Some big oopses, for if that is such a word, mistakes by the Wolves. In the last 3 drives, 2 on offense, and now this one on defense.
That's right. Flint Northern really had to give the ball up there to Central, and Central made a very costly mistake. You cannot run into the kicker. Now it just pretty much equates for Northern into a long pass play. They get the ball there. They might move across Central into Central territory, and they really didn't earn it. That would have been very good field position for the Central High Wolves, but now Flint Northern just moves them out of the hole, and they can move the ball up.
1st and 10 for the Vikings at their own 24-yard line. Another big penalty against the Wolves. Gives the Vikings another chance on their offensive team. Hand off to number 6, Beard. He cuts over to the left side. His tackle number 78, the singer, Patrick Malley, with a nice job on defense. Good tackle by Patrick. Good penetration. Gain of 2 yards on the play. 2nd down and 8 for the Vikings at their own 26-yard line. 3 minutes and 18 seconds and counting to go in the first half. Bay City Central 7 and the Flint Northern Vikings 7. Excellent Saginaw Valley League contest right here from Elmer Engel Stadium on Elmer Engel Night. 3 minutes to go in the first half. Vikings ball on their own 26-yard line. 2nd down on the fade. Sparks passes and it is complete. Out there to the left receiver, good job by number 1, Chris Whiprow, but an excellent catch by the receiver over there, number 40, Derek Lee, and he is an outstanding receiver. Great concentration, Josh, he's got a great set of hands.
That's right, I saw a little bit of bump in there looking for the ball. Chris Whiprow had a really good defensive position on that, but you're right, Derek Lee has really come up big. He's caught a couple long pass plays, and like a little fade like that when you can pick it up for a first down is a very good play, and Derek Lee is a very good wide receiver.
Excellent pass and excellent catch by the Flint Northern. A little hitch and go. Sparks got some pressure. He's trying to get away. Throws the ball down the left sidelines, and incomplete. Covering on the play for the Wolves, number 2, Dave DeRocher, number 1, Chris Whitbrook. pass was intended for number 40, Derek Lee, double coverage, but great pressure by the defensive line of the Bay City Central Wolves. And I'll tell you what, Sparks was backpedaling when he threw that ball, and he threw that ball close to 40 yards in the air. And that young man has got one heck of an iron to throw that ball that far, Josh.
That's right. The central defensive line had him backpedaling. He had to he pump faked and couldn't get the ball away. You're right. There was in double coverage over there, and he really did a good job of getting that ball away because the wide receiver almost had the catch.
Second and 10 for the Vikings. New look here by the Vikings. Split backfield. Sparks drops back the pass, looking to set up the screen. Great job by number 33, Jared Luski, to try to break up the screen. There is a penalty on the play. Beard, the ball carrier, he's going to go all the way for a northern touchdown. But hold on for 1 second. We do have a penalty flag all the way back here at the 40-yard line. So we are going to probably bring it back. I don't want to speak too soon, but there is a penalty. The referees are talking it over. And Jared Redluski did a nice job of breaking up the screen pass, but Beard got away anyway. Preliminary call, holding against the Vikings, and also blocking below the waist, quip against the Vikings. So what a huge, huge mistake by Flint Northern, and a great, great package for the Bay City Central Wolves to nullify that touchdown. That touchdown covered 60 yards. No good for the Vikings. Bring it back.
That's right. These Central Wolves coaches are very excellent coaches. They showed this Central Wolves team a lot of game film on Beard and the Northern Vikings. You're right about Jared Ratluski. He really stayed back. He saw that screen. He saw that he got through the line right away. And you have to read those type of things, especially as an outside linebacker and as a D lineman. You have to read what the linemen are doing. And that was a very good read by Jared Ratluski. And the rest of the line, frankly, they couldn't catch up to Beard, but they had the right frame of mind. They saw exactly what was going on. That's very intelligent for a team to be that quick on their feet and be able to think about what they're doing as they're running. And it's very intelligent of the coaches to show a lot of game film to the Central High Wolves and really get them informed on what the Northern High Vikings are doing.
They've got an outstanding coaching staff here at Bay City Central, from the freshman squad all the way up to the varsity. Just an outstanding group of men who are very dedicated to the cause, love what they're doing, love working for the kids. So take your hats off to the defense, Gene Rademacher, and the defensive squad. Sparks back the pass, another fade route. Cox on the receive on the defense. Almost completed out here to number 60-85 for the Northern Vikings.
Stocker. Stephen Stocker.
Didn't see his name there, Josh. I had to write it in there earlier. Stephen Stocker. Number 85, good defensive coverage by number 13, Brad Cox. A good pass just over the wrong shoulder for the Vikings. Third down and 20, 2 minutes and 62 seconds to go in the first half. Central 7, Bay City Central 7, excuse me, and Northern 7. And Josh, once again, looks like we're going to take it right down to the last tick of the clock.
I'll tell you what, Mike, this is going to be a very exciting football game. There's 2 minutes left to go in the first half, and I think that's a penalty.
I don't see any flags, Josh is saying. I don't see a flag.
Right.
It looked like a penalty up here, but it looked like Northern moved. Central jumped in really quick. I don't see a penalty at all. Central really quick to call a timeout. Great penetration by the defensive line of Bay City Central. Once again, smart coaching. Jay Davis getting that quick timeout. Once again, Central will end up with decent field position. A minute 54 to go in the first half with a 7-7 tie. Good job by Central defense. Sparks was going back to pass. Lost about 7 yards on the play, so it's fourth down and 27 to go for Northern at their own 27-yard line.
That's right. I think Central High's defense is really stepping up. They don't have the quick D-backs to get with the Flint Northern Vikings wide receivers, but they're really trying out there. Especially Brad Cox has been run on a couple of times, and he's really trying to step up and get in front of the ball. But this Northern squad is a very experienced squad, and they're doing well. They just need to hook up a little bit better on the pass and get their blockers out in the Central High backfield there. And get the blocks they need, and Beard will be gone. So I think both teams are doing very well on both sides of the ball. And here's a punt situation for Flint Northern.
Lakey back to kick for Flint Northern. Back to receive for the Central Wolves. Number one, Whip Row 21, Kirchhoff. And once again, Central's going to end up with excellent field position out of this fourth and long situation. Short, low line kick to number 21, Mike Kirchhoff. Looking for the reverse, going to fake the reverse, and a nice job by the Bay City Central or Flint Northern special teams number 8, Warren Williams. And it looked like there was a late hit on the play, Josh. Penalty on the play, probably going to be unnecessary roughness, personal foul against the Wolves. And once again, the Wolves with a huge penalty. They have good field position at this time, but that's going to move them back 15 yards deeper into their own territory.
Yeah, we hate to see Central High players involved in skirmishes like that, but you know, Brad Ackley, he's an intelligent player, and he's been doing well for Central. Looked like on that play, Mike Kirchhoff got backed up, and he really got stuffed by Warren Williams after that fake reverse, but it was a really good fake, and I look for Central to try and move the ball here. The score's tied. They have a little under 2 minutes to go in the half, and they really know that they need to move the ball up.
Well, Central's going to march back 15 yards. Referee's marking it all the way back. He keeps going all the way back close to the 30-yard line. Just outside the 30-yard line, be first and 10 for the Wolves at their own 31-yard line, we'll call it. Dead ball foul, personal foul against the Wolves. First and 10, 146 in the first half. Central 7, Northern 7. Once again, another squeaker here at Elmer Engel Stadium. Hand off to number 40, Mike Kirchhoff. He rumbles up the middle. Good hard running by Mike Kirchhoff. And he takes it all the way down to the Bay City Central 41-yard line. Excuse me, that was first and 25, Josh. Dead ball foul, so we'll move them back 15 yards. And it looks like we have an injured player on the field for Bay City Central.
It's Todd Gall.
Can't see his number, but Todd Gall looks like he's grabbing that right ankle again. So trainer Janet Clyde, who does an outstanding job. I'll tell you, Janet is an outstanding trainer. Also does an outstanding job in the classroom over at the Handy Intermediate School. Dedicated individual. She puts in a lot of time here with the kids at all sports for Bay City Central. And she's right there when she needs you. And she's a definite asset to the program here at Bay City Central.
That's right. Especially when a lot of other teams I see, they bring in just, you know, coaches and players, but you don't see a trainer come along with them. And that happens a lot. A lot of teams don't bring a trainer, and they don't have someone to care for them when they're injured. So Janet Clyde really is a very good specialist at treating people. I'm sure she'll have Todd Gall back in the field in no time. And she does a lot, you're right, for a lot of people in both schools.
Janet's husband, Dale, also on the staff here at Central. Assistant football coach at the varsity. Hand off to number 17, Leiterman. He rumbles off to the left side and is met there by number 2, Isaac Crawford, and the host of Vikings. But Mr. Leiterman's having an outstanding game tonight. Got a little turf on his helmet. Got the old turf helmet, and he'll leave it on there, make him look a little bit tougher. But nice run by Chad, and it's third down and 5 for the Wolves at their own 41-yard line.
That's right.
At their own 49-yard line.
With a little under a minute to go left, they're giving the ball to Chad Leiterman, and they're trying to pick up this first down. This will be a fourth down. I'm not sure if they're going to punt. They might have to, but it's going to be fourth and short, so they might end up going for it. About 40 seconds to go in the first half, and they'd like to bring it down here and maybe have a quick threat and score.
Chad Leiterman is coming into the game for number 40, Todd Gall, who re-injured his right ankle. He injured in the first quarter, sat out 4 or 5 plays. Chad Leiterman came in for him, did an excellent job. And Gall heard it again. Back to punt for the Wolves, number 12, Kevin Fredericks. Back to receive the punt for the Vikings, number 32, Adrian Boyd for the Vikings. And very important that the Wolves have outstanding special team play here. They're going to take the penalty, try to run out the clock, 6 seconds to go in the first half. Bay City Central 7, Flint Northern 7, and the Northern Vikings are going to have to receive the punt in their own territory. Special teams going to have to step up here, Josh. As you well know, number 32, Boyd, got a set of wheels on him. Let's hopefully the Wolves have a great special team play here. End over end kick. Fair catch by Boyd. Oh, it hit him! And turnover to Bay City Central. Hit number 32, Adrian Boyd. And the time has run out on the clock. And that's the end of the first half. What a way to end the first half, Josh. And that'll take care of the first half here at Elmer Engel Stadium on Elmer Engel Night, honoring the legendary coach of Bay City Central. Central 7, base and Flint Northern 7. An outstanding game, Josh. But I think the key to the first half is the Central Wolves had the ball down in the red zone a couple times and came away empty-handed after a big turnover and a big penalty.
That's right. I think, like I said, Bay City Central's got to be a lot more consistent when they bring it down in the red zone. They got down to the 5-yard line, the 3-yard line. They gave it to Gall, and he couldn't get in. He's a little bit hurt, and he's limping around. But Chad Leiterman's been holding water, too, so they have no excuse for not putting the ball in. I think they're going to come out fired up for the second half, and they're going to try not to give Flint Northern as many breaks as they gave them in the first half and get the ball game really moving, get the score really moving in their favor. And the second half, I think, proves to be a big Central.
And that's the end of the first half, 7-7 tie. We'll be back at the end of the halftime, and that'll be it. We'll see you in a couple minutes.
This summer's big blockbuster movie was Mission Impossible. Audiences left the theater humming the original TV theme, which features that familiar 5/4 time bass part. Our performance tonight will heat things up a bit by featuring our outstanding flag corps. One of the most identifiable themes from any spy movie was the haunting theme from the James Bond movie, For Your Eyes Only. The Waltz will conclude tonight's performance with this theme, featuring trumpet soloist Pat LaRue, Erica Curtis, and Steve Stratton, as well as horn soloist Jeff Blow. Central High School Band would like to take this opportunity to thank Jack's Fruit Market for their generous donation of apples to the marching band. Thank you.
Welcome back, everybody, from a great halftime show from Michigan's oldest continuous marching band. And I'll tell you, Josh, that was a great show with all the spy themes, songs going on. What an outstanding job by Central High School Marching Band once again. Tremendous music, and they got the crowd pumped up. We're ready to go for an exciting second half of Saginaw Valley League action. 7-7 tie between the Northern Vikings and the Central Wolves. Bravo kicks off. Short end over end kick to number one, Mike Childress. He takes the ball, is met there by number two for the Wolves, Dave DeRocher. First and 10 for the Vikings on their own 37 yard line. And Josh, first half was a half of big plays and big penalties for both teams.
That's right. Flint Northern is doing very well. And so is Bay City Central. They're doing a lot for on offense and defense, and they're moving the ball as well as stopping. So it looks like it's going to be an interesting game going down. We just started the second half, of course. If you just tuned in, score 7-7. Flint Northern's got their ball on their own 33-yard line, first and 10.
First and 10 for the Vikings. Sparks, the quarterback, calling out the signals. Hands off to number six, Ida Beard. He's trying to get outside. Ida's got some speed, but caught from behind on a great defensive play by number 20, Jay Davis, on the tackle. And Ida had a little bit of real estate in front of him, but a good defensive play by Jay Davis, but not after Ida Beard picked up 7 yards. Second and 3 for the Vikings at their own 39-yard line, and that gentleman can pick him up and put him down, Josh. If he gets outside, it's all over but the crying.
That's right. Like we talked about at the beginning of the first half, he was really the one that beat up on Central last year. He had about 300 yards rushing, and he can really move, so we look for him to be explosive in the second half.
Second and 3 for the Vikings, and a nice defensive job by the Central Wolves, brought down by number 53, Jack Mao. Also in on the play, number 20, Jay Davis, and number 34, Brett Vrabel. No gain on the play. Third down and 3 for the Vikings at their own 40-yard line. Nice defensive stand to start the second half by the Bay City Central Wolves. Third and a long 2, we'll call it, for the Vikings at their own 41-yard line, just starting in the second half. Big play right here to start the second half for the Central defensive team. Sparks, the quarterbacks for the Vikings, barking out the signals. Hands out to number 6, and rolls around right in. Good fake handoff, flag on the play. Brought down by number 2, Dave DeRocher. He did get the first down, but there is a penalty flag back called by the umpire, and that is always a familiar bad sign for the offense. Offensive holding against Northern Vikings, and a big break for the Central Wolves. Holding against the offense, bring it all the way back, and again, Central gets the break with a big penalty against Northern Vikings.
That's right, that is a big break. The Flint Northern team comes out, and they get into a tough third down situation, their own end of the field, and they came out and tried to pick that up, and they did a really good job, except for the holding penalty. So that's a big job. It's a big break for the Bay City Central Wolves, who back up the Flint Northern squad, and they go from third and about, looks like maybe 15 on this play, and if they can't get out of their own side of the field, they're going to have to punt.
Once again, if that happens, Josh, good field position for the Wolves. And deep down the field in his defensive back, number 2, Dave DeRocher, looking like double coverage over here on number 40 for the Vikings, Derek Lee. But Sparks back the pass, intercepted and dropped by number 43, Brad Jones. He had the rock in his hands. He decided to run before he had control, and I'll tell you what, he's got to feel awful disappointed because Mr. Jones had the rock in his hand, Josh, and just let it slip through. But that's okay. That was makes it fourth down and 14, but Brad had some real estate. Once again, Central's going to come away with excellent field position.
That's right. Brad's an old-school tight end, and he used to play a lot of tight end when he was younger, and I think he'd like to have his hands on the ball and get running instead of being on defense. So he got a little bit excited there and dropped it, but that's all right. I think they would have had a lot better field position, but this still gives them really good position, and they should be able to move the ball down and try and strike.
End over end kick. You got a foot north of roll. Roll past Mike Kirchhoff, but he picked it up and gained about 1 yard on the play, all the way down to their own 30-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for the Wolves at their own 30-yard line. 9 minutes, 40 seconds to go in the third quarter. We do have a Northern player down. number 83, Nigel Swain, hurt on the play. And Josh, while we have a timeout on the field, let's take a look at the playoff points for Region 1. Central High School, nice enough to give us the updated playoff computerized rankings for this week.
That's right. Muskegon sits atop the playoff points in their region number one with 94.4, and they're 5-0. They're really a powerhouse. Lansing Eastern follows them up with 91.2. Rockford, Lansing Sexton, Bay City Central come right behind that. And playoff points are really big, and especially in the Valley, because a lot of teams have to compete, and they come out of the Valley, and the Valley doesn't get a lot of respect around with teams like Muskegon, who are powerhouses every year. And a lot of times the bigger schools will run over schools like Northern and the smaller Flint teams. So a lot of like the Flint Northern team tonight and Bay City Central are both fighting for some playoff points and a chance to get up in the rankings.
Playoff implications for every game from here on out for Bay City Central. And they're going to go first and 10 on their own 30-yard line, 9 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the third quarter. Kevin Fredericks, Todd Gull, and Mike Kirchhoff split out to the left. Number 9, Jeff Frazier, hand off to number 21, Mike Kirchhoff, and he finds no running room around the right side. Excellent defensive job by number 34, Willie McNabb, and number 65, Cameron Logan. Excellent defense by the Northern Vikings. Mike Kirchhoff just cannot find any running room on either side of the offensive line. Northern keen on Kirchhoff and can't find any real estate to run the ball. Loss of 4 yards on the play. Second and 14 for the Wolves at their own 26-yard line. Big, huge defensive play right there by Willie McDabb, playing an outstanding game from his defensive linebacker position. Hand off to number 17, Chad Leiderman. He rumbles across the 35-yard line. Fumble on the play. And the referee hasn't made a decision yet. It looks like they're pointing down. It's going to be third down and 4 yards for the Wolves. Referee said the play had been stopped and that the central ball player was down. So once again, a big break for the Wolves. Gain of about 12 yards on the play. Call it third down and a long two for the Central Wolves. And old Josh, I'll tell you what, the pigskin was loose. But once again, the Wolves got a huge break there.
That's right. That is a big break. Last week we saw Traverse City. Chris Whitbro coughed up the ball, and it was very costly with a touchdown. So we hope Chad Leiderman holds on to the ball for the rest of the game.
Number 17, Leiderman, from his fullback position, carries the ball across the 50-yard line, and there is a penalty flag on the play. Preliminary indication forthcoming. Not 8 minutes and 5 seconds to go in a tightly, highly contested ball game. 7-7 tie. Illegal procedure. Bay City Central. That will move them back 5 yards. And once again, the Yellow Hankies coming up to bite the Bay City Central Wolves on a huge offensive play.
That's right. That was a big pickup by Chad Leiderman. And they really need to move the ball down the home stretch. You can't take penalties when you're the score's tied up and you're on a third down. So it looks like Central needs to buckle down here a little bit and move the ball up, get a first down, cross midfield, and try and score here.
First, third and 8 for the Wolves at their own 27-yard line. Split out to the left, number 9, Jeff Frazier. Number 20, Jay Davis in the wing to the right. Leiderman, the fullback. And Kevin Fredericks rolls out to his left. Finds Brad Ackley and just off his fingertips. Hit there by number 2, Isaac Crawford. Just off the fingertips of number 5, Brad Ackley. Just a tad behind, but a very catchable ball. It'll make a fourth down and 8 for the Wolves at their own 32. That'll be a punting situation for the Wolves. Back to punt number 12 for the Wolves, Kevin Fredericks. Back to receive the punt number 32 for the Vikings, Adrian Boyd. Clock running, 7:44 to go. A high spiral. Getting away from the ball is the Flint North player. Takes a northern bounce, and it is down there by number 17, Leiderman. inside Central Territory, a high kick but a northern bounce. It'll be first and 10 for the Vikings at the Central 48-yard line.
That's right. That gives Flint Northern a little bit of good field position here. Central High has been the one getting the big breaks on the field position, and they've been able to move in on the red zone. So it's a good little change for the Northern Vikings here. They get to start off in Bay City Territory, and hopefully they'll... I'm sure they hope to move the ball up into Central's red zone and score.
7:35 to go in the third quarter. A squeaker here from Elmer Engel Stadium. 7-7 tie in this Saginaw Valley League contest between Central and Flint Northern. First and 10, Sparks hands off to number 6, Beard. He rumbles off to the right side, off right tackle. Gain of about 4 yards on the play. Call it second and 6 for the Northern Vikings at the Bay City Central 43-yard line, 44-yard line, just inside the 45. Second and 6 for the Vikings at inside Bay City Central territory. Sparks the quarterback, the workhorse for the Northern Vikings, and a power eye right now. Different look by the Vikings. We haven't seen this formation all night, 7 minutes and counting. 7-7 our score here from Elmer Engel Stadium. Sparks hands off to number 6. It's a fumble on the play. I think Flint Northern got it back. They're still scrumming down there. Number 53, Jack Mullen. Number 33, Jared Ratluski. But there is a fumble on the play. But I do believe, Josh, that Flint Northern did recover their own fumble. And I got a sneaky feeling that a big turnover down towards the end of this game is going to decide the outcome of who wins and who loses this ball game tonight.
That's right. It's going to be a squeaker right down to the end, and I think you're right. It could come out just being a big break for one team or the other. And with the score tied 7-7, usually the best offense right now in Bay City, you know, they had the best offense in the valley, and they should be able to move the ball a lot better than this. So it looks like it's going to be an exciting ending to a good ball game.
Central's defense, number 6 total defense in the valley. According to our stats, coming out here is number 6, Beard, and a great defensive play by number 20, Jay Davis, to trip him up. And number 1, Chris Wimbrough, came up from his defensive back position to finish him off. But I'll tell you, Jay Davis came out of nowhere, shot out of a gun, did a nice job, and Jay's having a great game on defense, Josh, along once again with number 1, Chris Wimbrough.
That's right, and I think one of the things that Gene Rademacher did at halftime is took Brad Cox off of number 40, Derek Lee, the wide receiver who's been threatening this Bay City Central defense, and he put him over in the middle and put Chris Whitbrow on Derek Lee, so the speed that Chris Whitbrow brings to the Central defensive backcourt could really prove costly to the Flint Northern Vikings.
Lakey's kick goes to number 1, Chris Whitbrow. He gets away from one tackle, gets away from another, comes up the right sideline. It's met by a host of Flint Northern Vikings, led by number 8, Warren Williams. But a nice return by Chris Whitbrow. No flags on the play. That's a good sign for the Central Wolves. First and 10 for the Wolves at their own 33.5-yard line. Good opportunity for the Wolves here to take a little bit of time off the clock. 5 minutes, 4 seconds to go in the third quarter, 7-7 tie. And I think the last team to have the rock, Josh, is the team that's going to win this ball game.
I can see that happening. I think both these teams are doing extremely well, and both coaching staffs are doing extremely well. So I think you're right. It's going to come down to either the last team with the ball or the last break, the last big break that happens.
Leiterman, the ball carrier, in there for the injured Todd Gall, who injured his ankle in the first and second quarter, injured it first in the first quarter, re-injured it in the second quarter, just unable to go at this time. Leiterman's doing a nice job replacing 4 yards on the game. Second down and 6 for the Wolves at their own 37-yard line. Jay Davis over here, number 20, to the right wing. Split out to the left, number 4, Adam Mallory. Kevin Fredericks, the quarterback, fakes the handoff, rolls out to his left. This play's been working all night long. Number 17, Leiterman, coming out of the backfield, and a nice job by Kevin Fredericks, not only faking the handoff, rolling out to his left, being very patient, waiting for Leiterman to find the seam, and throwing a nice pass to Leiterman. First and 10 for the Wolves at the 50-yard line.
Kevin Fredericks has got a really consistent fake. If he screws up a throw every once in a while, that's to be expected. But his fake has always been there. It always gives him a lot of time to look, be patient with his receivers, let the routes develop, and he hit Chad Leiterman right in the letters that time. So that's a good gain.
Leiterman, the ball carrier, following his blockers, had a hand on the back of one of his offensive linemen, and he's still struggling for yards. He's brought down by a host of Flint Northern Vikings, led by number 16, Chris Edmonds, and also in their number 40, Derek Lee, 34, McNabb, also in. What a nice game by Leiterman. Like we said in the first half, Josh, second down and 9 yards. Leiterman is a pleasant surprise for the Central High School coaching staff. When Todd Gall is injured, it seems like Mr. Leiterman can handle the position extremely well.
That's right, and he's still young. He's going to have a lot of time next year to develop after Gall leaves, and he's going to be a really explosive fullback next year.
Nice pass by Kevin Fredericks. Brad Ackley, number 5, looked before he caught the ball. I think you heard the footsteps of the Flint Northern defender. He had a first down, hit him right in the numbers, but Brad dropped the ball. Third and short for the Central Wolves on the Flint Northern 42-yard line. Third and two, and before I forget, Josh, we'd like to say thank you for the sponsors of tonight's show and all the shows we've done here from Ingalls Stadium. The Bay City Central Booster Club, they do an outstanding job. We'll talk a little bit more after this play. Leiterman, the ball carrier, he's close to a first down, and it does look like he made it across the 40-yard line. And it'll be first and 10 for the Wolves at the Northern 40. But once again, thank you to the Booster Club. They do an outstanding job, not only for the athletic teams, but also for the non-athletic teams and the extracurricular activities, selling the pop and selling the hot dogs. And they're here early and leaving late, so we'd like to thank them for sponsoring our program tonight.
That's right. It's very pleasant to have a group of people that care that much about Central football and the Central school. They come out, you're right, they come early and they leave late, and they do a lot for everyone here. And it's pleasant to be able to bring people the ball game on television when they might not have been able to get out to the stadium here at Elmer Engel Stadium and feel the Friday night game, but they can watch it on TV on the tape. So
a lot of people behind the scenes doing an outstanding job here at Engel Stadium. All the administrators and the maintenance staff doing an outstanding job getting this field ready. And Kevin Fredericks on the quarterback sneak, and he picked up a ton of yardage on that play. First and 10 for the Wolves at the Northern 34-yard line. It was third and short for the Wolves. Kevin Fredericks picks up the first down. Central has an outstanding drive going tonight. And tonight we're also going to let you know that Bay City Western's at Flint Northwestern. Midland's at Flint Southwestern, Mount Pleasant's at Dow, Flint Central had a huge game at Saginaw High, Trojans number 2 in the state, Class A, and Arthur Hill's at Heritage. Kirchhoff, the ball carrier, caught from behind, excellent defensive play by number 81, Carlos Gill, and Josh, Mike just can't seem to get on track tonight. They got his number, they're keeping a close eye on Kirchhoff. They don't want him to have anything to do with any type of yardage.
That's right. He's Central's most explosive runner, and every team they face knows that. So they try to contain him the best they can, and Flint Northern's done very well at doing that. Gall and Leiterman have been running on them, but they'd much rather have the fullback run and gain 5 yards of carry than Kirchhoff bust out for a 60-yard gain.
Loss of 2 on a play. Here's a familiar play, a rollout. Number 43, Brad Jones, the ball carrier, the pass receiver, incomplete. Nice pass by Kevin Fredericks. He really had to thread the needle. Brad Jones had it, and he dropped it when he was hit. But Kevin Fredericks, right on target again. A loss of 2 on the first down play a couple plays ago. Third and 12 for the Wolves at the Northern 35-yard line. 1 minute, 49 seconds to go in the third quarter. 7-7 tie on Elmer Engel night, honoring the old football coach from Bay City Central. He's seen an outstanding ball game tonight, Josh. Third and 12 for the Wolves at the Northern 35-yard line. Big offensive play. Kevin Fredericks drops back to pass. He sees number 9, Frazier. It's tipped by number 9. Frazier catches the ball. Touchdown, Bay City Central. Nice concentration by that young man. The ball was tipped. by a Northern player. Then it was tipped by Jeff Frazier, and he caught his own tip and a touchdown, Bay City Central, making the score Central 13 and Flint Northern 7. And that was shades of last week, Josh.
That's right. The crazy things happened last week, and we're going down into the fourth quarter now, and that's one of the breaks that Central needed to get their crowd back into it here on Elmer Angle night. And now they've got Northern by a touchdown, and they got a little bit of momentum to ride down in the fourth quarter. Jeff Frazier with extreme concentration on that play. Everyone should tip your hat to that young man, because he really have to focus on the ball in that situation. You realize if you catch it, it's going to be a touchdown, and if you don't, it's not. So he really had to concentrate, focus on that ball, bring it down in his mitts, and take it to the end zone.
Everybody having a good time here at Angle Stadium after that impressive drive by the Central Wolves and an impressive catch by number 9, Jeff Frazier. That makes the score Bay City Central 14, Flint Northern 7, and number 34, Vrabel, back the kick for Bay City Central, back to receive number 20 for the Vikings, Jamal Lattimore, and also number 32, Adrian Boyd. But what a big touchdown for the Wolves. Kevin Frederick threw it on a line, and it was tipped, and Jeff Frazier, using the old tip drill that they do every day in practice for the defensive backs, he caught the ball off to the tip and went in for a big Central score.
That's right. Here goes Brent Vrabel with the kickoff, who's been very, very consistent this year on kicking the ball. He really gets it deep, and we like to see that. The special teams play in Bay City Central football especially is very important. They like to get good field position a lot of times, and they've been doing that consistently in the game, and they've been putting Flint Northern back on their heels with the special teams. So it really helps to go along to good complement with your offense and defense if you can put the other team at a disadvantage right from the get-go.
Postanati works awful hard on that special team. He's the special teams coach. First and 10 for the Northern Vikings on their own 34-yard line. Central 14, Northern 7, 1:36 to go in the third quarter. Sparks the quarterback in a power eye, hands off to Ida Beer. He's met there by number 78, Patrick Malley. Also went on the play, number 2, Dave DeRocher. Beer picks up about 6 yards on the play. Second down and 4 yards to go for the Vikings on their own 41-yard line. Once again, my name is Mike Wisdella, along with Josh Smith. We're bringing you Bay 3 TV Sports on the Air, Saginaw Valley League action right here from Elmer Angle Stadium. Bay City Central High School with the lead, 14-7. Second down and 4 for the Vikings. Beard again, the ball carried off the right side, and he scoops through for a Northern Viking first down. And that was close, Josh. He had a big hole there. Once again, on the tackle, number 20, Jay Davis, who's having an outstanding defensive game from his defensive backfield position.
That's right. Bay City Central's trying to tighten down the defense for the home stretch, and I really like the philosophy of the Central coaches trying to get everybody into the game, and Chris Woodrow has stepped up to Derek Lee on the wide receiver side, and they're not going to him as much. Like you said, Jay Davis is having a good game, Brad Jones, everybody on that defensive squad. So they're trying to limit Flint Northern's explosiveness. Ida Beard has not been able to move the ball very well this game. And when you neutralize the team's running back, they have to go to other areas of the game. And they really like to tighten the screws for the fourth quarter.
Dead ball foul encroachment against the Bay City Central Wolves. That'll move the ball up 5 yards. It'll be first and 5 for the Vikings at the Bay City Central 49-yard line. First and 5 for the Vikings. And once again, 14-7 Central in the lead, 35 seconds and counting, here from Elmer Angle Stadium. Elmer Angle Knight honoring Coach Angle. Some of his players are back, families here, friends. So a very festive night once again. 23 seconds to go in the third quarter. Northern Vikings have the ball inside Bay City Central territory. Sparks barking out the signals, rolling out here to the left, looking for number 40, Derek Lee. He's got the reception, he's brought down by number 1, Chris Whitrow, but not after a big game for the Vikings. All the way down for the Bay City Central 12-yard line, and number 40, Lee, is hurt on the play, and it looks like he came down on his head, Josh, when he was tackled by Whitrow. And that young man came down awful hard. He's an outstanding football player, and we hope that everything will be all right for Derek Lee, number 40 of the Vikings.
That's right. He's been an explosive receiver on this game for Flint Northern, and they're trying to isolate him. Like I said, they put Whitbrow on him, who might be a little bit quicker than his counterpart, Brad Cox. But he's still, that's great concentration by Derek Lee to get out there, catch that ball, and brings Flint Northern down into a striking situation where they got first and goal. And this is what they need to get back in this ball game. They have 11 seconds to go before the fourth quarter, and they'd really like to score here to even it out and put it back in, you know, an even even score to go down the home stretch here. But Central's trying to tighten up their defense, of course, and we'll see what happens here at first and goal.
Looking at our Valley stats, Lee is the leading receiver in the Valley, 391 yards, 17 receptions, 4 touchdowns for a 23-yard average. So it's not surprising that Sponge likes to throw to Lee. And that is the end of the third quarter with the score, Bay City Central Wolves 14, Flint Northern Vikings 7. Flint Northern is knocking on the door. First and goal, the goal for the Vikings on the Bay City Central 7-yard line. And Josh, it's once again, it's the big plays that seem to be coming up and biting the Wolves. Big pass plays, but you can't fault the effort by the defensive backfield. Sparks and Lee are connected, and they're doing a good job. It's just pinpoint passing by Flint Northern.
That's right. Just like Bay City Central's defense has tried to tighten up the connection between Sparks and Derek Lee have been they've been trying to hook that up all night. They've been just missing it. Lee hasn't been able to lay out and catch the ball. It's been overthrown a little bit, but now they're starting to hook up and they're starting to get in sync. So it looks like they might have a good little tandem. They're going down the home stretch, to just like Leiterman and Gall have been sticking it to Northern. That might be the answer for Flint Northern.
Other games going on in the region one. Number one, Muskegon, number one team in the region, plays at Traverse City. That'll be a whale of a ball game up in the Great White North. Lansing Eastern, number two, plays at Holt. Rockford, number three, plays at Granville, who's undefeated. Number Grand Ledge, who is number 10, plays at Lansing Sexton, who is number four. So there's some playoff implications going around the state, Josh. And if Bay City Central comes out of this with a win, and if Muskegon gets beat by Traverse City, Central will be right back in the playoff hunt in the top four possibly. So very important game for the Wolves here at Ingalls Stadium. Hand off to number 33 for the Vikings. Number 33, Cartavian Woodley, I think is his name. I'm not quite sure. And he gets down inside the 5-yard line. Second and goal for the Vikings on the Bay City Central 3-yard line. Nice run by the Vikings, knocking on the door, 11:34 and counting to go in the game, Josh.
That's right. Central's defense really has to knuckle up right here and try and stop the Flint Northern Vikings, because they've had the momentum, and this has been a nice drive. It'll put a lot of wind back in the sails of the Northern Vikings, and they're going to have to... That's a touchdown.
Woodley, the ball carry for the Vikings. Touchdown, Flint Northern. An impressive drive by the Vikings, making the score Central 14, Northern 13. Waiting for the extra point. 11 minutes, 16 seconds to go in the ball game, and Northern's right back in this ball game. Big extra point coming for the Vikings. So once again, we're going to go right down the wire. Typical Saginaw Valley League game, Josh. Back and forth we go, and official timeout on the field. Central's defense giving up a big pass play to number 40, Derek Lee, top receiver in the Valley. Extra point forthcoming, 14-13. And like we said before, Josh, we're going to go right down to the wire. Typical Saginaw Valley League action.
That's right. That Flint Northern team, they really had got a good drive right there. You're right, the Derek Lee and Nick Sparks really threw the ball down there and hurt him with that big pass play. And Central, you'd like to see Central tighten up their ball game, especially in defense, because last week we saw Traverse City come out and use up 8-9 minutes of the clock at a time on two separate drives. And when you can eat the clock up and score, It really proves costly, you know, for the other team. They can't get back in the game as well. So now that Central's getting the ball back, you'd like to see them eat up the clock instead of Flint Northern, who's right back in this ball game after that, making the score 14-14.
Also mentioned some Valley stats. Beard from Flint Northern, the number one scoring back in the Valley. He has a total of 59 points, 9 touchdowns, and 5 point after touchdowns. Todd Gull has 42 points, 7 touchdowns from Todd Gull. Receiving number one is Lee, like we mentioned. Bay City Central's Chris Whitbroad is third in the Valley, 294 yards, 13 receptions, 2 touchdowns for a high average of 22.6 yards per catch. Rushing is number four in the Valley is Todd Gull. And Kevin Fedrick's the number one passer in the Valley with 707 total yards, 61 attempts, 28 completions, 46% completion rate, 6 TDs and 3 interceptions. So Bay City Central has some leaders on this team in the Valley statistics. They are leading the Valley with 4 wins and no losses, tied with Saginaw High, which Central does not play this year. So they 4-0 both teams. Flint Central's 3-2, Midland's 3-2, Flint Northern's 3-2. Southwestern and Arthur Hill are 2-2 coming into the night. Dow and Bay City Western are 2-3, Flint Northern and Heritage are 0-5. So very interesting up at the top of the pack in the Valley.
That's right. And you talk about the leaders they have in the Central High team, especially in the last 4 or 5 years. Central's had consistent teams. They've had a lot of stars on their team and a lot of people that just plain play football. And they got a lot of those people this year. So it looks like it's going to be an exciting season all the way through for the Bay City Central Wolfcats.
Kick off to the number one, Chris Whitbroad. He bobbles it for a second. He's got a little bit of real estate up the middle, and he is brought down after a nice game. Brought down at about the 42-yard line, but Chris Whitbroad bobbled it, picked it up, and had a nice return all the way down to their own 42-yard line. First and 10 for the Wolves at the 42. Once again, my name is Mike Wisdella, along with Josh Smith and Mike Brule in the truck tonight, showing us, giving you all the nice camera angles. There's a nice shot by our camera up on top of the Central Gymnasium. Once again, I'd like to thank the camera folks for doing an outstanding job bringing in the game tonight. First and 10 for the Wolves at their own 42-yard line. There's Mike Kirchhoff. First time all night, Josh, that he got just a little bit of running room. Gain of 4 on the play, 2nd and 6 for the Wolves.
That's right. Chad Leiterman and Todd Gull have had to carry the load here for Central's running game, and you really like to see Mike Kirchhoff get into the game a little bit more and get into carrying the ball, because he's a really explosive back, and when he gets a hole, he can use it. So he's being wrapped up very nicely by the Flint Northern defensive package.
2nd and 6 for the Wolves at their own 45-yard line. Hand off to Chad Leiterman. And for probably the first time tonight, he gained absolutely nothing on the play. It'll be 3rd down and 6 for the Wolves at their own 45-yard line. 14-14 tie here at Ingalls Stadium between the Central High School Wolves and the Flint Northern Vikings. Also like to mention that the Bay City Central JVs are having an outstanding season. They are 4-1, and the Central Pat Brady Central freshman, they came into this week with a 2-2 record. So big things happening on the lower levels. If you ever want to see some great football, come on out to Ingalls Stadium and enjoy Saginaw Valley League action. Kevin DeFrancis rolls up to the right. He sees number 20, Jay Davis, over the middle, and it's complete to Jay Davis. Flag on the play. Outstanding job by number 12, Kevin Fredericks, to get away from the pressure. And he had enough sense to get rid of the ball to number 20, Jay Davis. And there is a flag on the play. I think they're going to call it pass interference. But Jay did hang out of the ball anyway. Great job by those two young men. Fredericks getting away from the pressure, throwing the ball to Jay Davis. Outstanding play for the Wolves.
That's right. And Jay Davis, who's normally more of a defensive back, just like Brad Jones, who's been playing a lot of monster back, middle linebacker for the Bay City Central defense, comes in and he plays wing very well. He plays tight end after Brad Ackley has lost his helmet and taken a couple of penalties and gotten a little hot-headed. Brad Brad Jones will come in, and they're both those guys are playing on both sides of the ball, and they're both doing very well. So it comes right back to basically Central's coaching, the way they use all their players, the way they're using Leiterman, the way they're letting Fredericks do what he needs to do to move the ball, and it really comes down to a good coaching staff and a good team altogether.
Offsetting penalties, Josh, Kevin Fredericks was across the line of scrimmage, so they'll bring it back there and pass interference. Offsetting, here goes that play again. Kevin's got a little bit of real estate. He sees number two, Dave DeRocher, down the middle of the field, and an excellent job, Dave DeRocher, sneaking in the scene. Kevin Fredericks, once again, Kevin Fredericks is carrying out his fakes. All the Flint Northern Vikings are going away from Kevin Fredericks. He's setting up, lost a nice soft pass to Dave DeRocher, and an outstanding game for the Bay City Central Wolves, all the way down to the Flint Northern 18-yard line. First and 10 for the Wolves at the Flint Northern 18-yard line.
He really launched a little bit of a floater there. I wasn't sure if one of the D-backs was going to get on that ball, but it was really nicely placed. Dave DeRocher was open.
Hand off to number 21, Mike Kirchhoff, and he finds some real estate, and he knew sooner or later, Josh, that Mike was going to get some room to run. He rumbles down inside the base, or the northern 5-yard line, first and 10 for the Wolves at the northern 4-yard line, knocking on the door, Bay City Central. Now, Josh, what they got to do inside the red zone, they got to put the ball in the end zone right here.
That's right, and it comes back to good coaching again. They really have to have good play calling right here, and they I'm sure they tightened up the blocking scheme during halftime, so it's getting Kirchhoff a little bit open now here in the home stretch.
Hand off to number 17, Chad Leiterman. No gain on the play. Outstanding defensive play by number 30 for the Vikings, Harrison. Outstanding job by that linebacker. Also in the play, number 34, McNabb, and Beard also in on there. Second and goal, loss on the play of 2 yards. Second and goal for the Wolves at the 6-yard line. Outstanding defense by Northern. Coming out to the left, number 4, Adam Ellery. Kevin Fredericks, the quarterback. Kirchhoff and Leiterman in the backfield. Jay Davis on the wing. Hand off to Leiterman. No gain on the play, maybe a gain of one. Third and goal for the Wolves at the northern 5-yard line.
This is shades of what they did last time they were down here by the 5-yard line. They're not really being very consistent about moving the ball. They can move the ball in the open field anytime they want to. They're really being consistent in the open field. They get down in the red zone, and they're not being very consistent about moving the ball. So it's proof costly. They messed up two scoring attempts earlier in the game, including a field goal. And this one cannot be missed by the Central Wolfpack. They need to score.
Kevin Fredericks rolls out to his left. It's caught by number 40 for the Wolves, Derek Lee, but he got the pass away. Incomplete, and a good, smart heads-up play by Kevin Fredericks. And once again, the Wolves cannot punch it into the end zone, so it's going to be fourth and goal for the Wolves at the northern 6-yard line. Looks like Coach Frazier has decided to go for the field goal. The last time we were down here, Josh, Northern got great penetration and blocked the kick. So let's see what happens this time. A huge field goal try by Kevin Fredericks. 7:51 to go in the game. The kick is up. The snap is, and it is blocked again by the Northern Vikings. And once again, the Wolves come away with no points. Still 14-14 tie to go. 7:47 left in our ball game. From Elmer Engel Stadium, the Wolves have been inside the red zone 3 times, Josh, and came away empty-handed, ball all the way out to the 20-yard line for the Vikings.
That's right. Bay City Central is really getting an education here about how they should be using their special teams a little bit better. There's a little seam there on the right side of the field goal unit, and Flint Northern is taking advantage of that, as well as a couple other points in the Central High offense. So especially when special teams, you know, when Central can't get their special teams unit going, that really loosens the screws on their whole team. And when you can't get breaks from your special team, you have a hard time on defense and offense.
First and 10 for the Vikings at their own 20-yard line. And big missed field goal by Kevin Fredericks. That's the second time tonight the ball's been blocked, and they were also down inside the red zone for a touchdown. If I'm not mistaken, that ball was intercepted by Northern. So 3 big scoring opportunities nullified by Northern's defense against Bay City Central. 14-14 tie, 7:47 to go in the Saginaw Valley League contest. Elmer Engel Stadium, once again, I'm Mike Wisdella, Josh Smith, Mike Pruhl in the truck, showing you the camera angles and doing an outstanding job for the ball game tonight. Exciting action right here from Engel Stadium on Elmer Engel night. Crowd is kind of eerily silent all of a sudden, Josh. Not a lot going on.
Well, that's what happens when Bay City Central misses three scoring attempts. They had two field goals blocked, like you said, and they had that other pass intercepted. So they're really not scoring very well. They can move the ball, but if you can't score, you can't win a ball game. And the score's tied. This is shades of what happened again last week in here with Traverse City. They got the ball in the fourth quarter. They moved it down. They ate up the clock, and Central didn't have enough time. They had enough gas, but they didn't have enough time to bring the ball back down and get a score.
Good point, Josh. A lot of time left in this game. 7:19 and counting. Beard was a ball carrier in the last play, brought down by a pack of wolves. Gain of a short 1 yard. Second down and 9 for the Vikings at their own 21-yard line. And Central's defense jumping around trying to draw the Northern Vikings outside. Jack Miles doing a job. And Sparks rolls out here to his left. He's got some real estate pressure on him. The ball is underthrown and is almost intercepted by number 2, Dave DeRocher, out there for the reception. Intended receiver, number 40, Derek Lee. But good pressure by number 33, Jared Ratluski. Incomplete pass, making it 3rd down and 9 for the Northern Vikings at their own 20-yard line. And if they come away, Josh, Central will come again away again with excellent field position if they hold them on this 3rd and 9 point.
That's right. 3rd and 9 is a very important play, especially when you're on your own 20-yard line. And Central's defense really stepped it up on that last play. I liked what I saw. They were in quadruple coverage on Derek Lee, and Jared Ratluski really brings something to the pass rush.
3rd down and 9 for the Vikings at their own 21-yard line. Have to be very careful here. Hand off to number 6, Beard. He's trying to get outside. Great job by number 12, Kevin Fredericks, holding them inside. It looks like there's a loose ball, but Beard got it back. But number 12, Kevin Fredericks, stepped up, made Beard turn the play back in, and then he's brought down by number 43, Brad Jones. Number 52, Swinehart of the Ratluski, also went on the play. But outstanding play by Kevin Fredericks, turning the play back in, letting his friends in the purple uniforms contain Beard and bring him down before he didn't get the first down. 4th and 3 for the Vikings at their 27-yard line. They will punt the ball. Lakey will punt to number 21, Kirchhoff, and number 1, Chris Whitbrook.
That's right. Coach Gene Rademacher really stresses angle of pursuit type things in Bay City Central practice, and that's one of the things they practice as well. They need to get in and turn the running back around sometimes and just get him back to the other purple jerseys. Not a lot of times they don't want people going one-on-one. They just want them to turn around.
Whitbrook takes the punt from Lakey, and a nice return by Chris Whitbrook. He duped and jived and danced a little bit, jitterbugged his way into Northern territory, all the way down to the 37-yard line, excuse me. There is a Northern player hurt on the play, but a nice return by Chris Whitbrook. And that was a huge play by Whitbrook, giving the Bay City Central Wolves excellent field position. 1st and 10 for the Wolves on the Northern 38-yard line.
That's right. You don't usually see someone run like Chris Whitbrook and just be so cautious and dance around. Usually a lot of full-speed head running will get you more yardage, but he's been dancing around. That's the second time tonight. He's moved around, juked a few guys, and picked up some extra yardage with it. Usually you only see that with guys like Kirchhoff and Barry Sanders, frankly. So Chris Whitbrook is doing a good job when he gets a hold of the ball, just moving around, juking the Flint Northern defenders, and moving the ball.
Looking into the student section here at Bay City Central, everybody once again having a great time on a great night for football here at Elmer Engel Stadium, honoring Coach Engel tonight, and everybody's having fun. The Northern players taking off the field, we're about ready to go 5 minutes, 45 seconds to go in the ball game. 14-14 tie, Central with the ball inside Northern Territory at the 38-yard line. Kevin Fredericks hands off to number 21, Mike Kirchhoff, around the left side, and he has a nice game of 8 yards on the play all the way down to the 30-yard line. Second and two for the Wolves, and it's just a matter of time before Mike Kirchhoff started finding some real estate. And he's been a marked man, Josh, and they remember that young man from last year. So every time somebody played at Bay City Central, they're looking for Mike Kirchhoff, but they're forgetting about Mr. Leiterman and Mr. Gall also.
That's right. Last year, when they played on the turf at Atwood Stadium, Mike Kirchhoff couldn't really get out of the gate with Northern either. So it looks like you know, they're containing him very well, and every team remembers him. But you're right, Chad Leiterman and Todd Gall both have been moving the ball consistently, and Central is about to enter Flint Northern's red zone. Looks like just 5:04 left to go in the ball game, and this could be like what we talked about earlier, Mike. It could be the last team with the ball could end up with the score, and it could be the difference in the ball game.
First and 10 for the Wolves at the Northern 24-yard line. Out here to the left, number 9, Jeff Frazier, Kevin Fredericks, Kirchhoff, and Leiterman in the backfield. And he's barking out the signals, hands off to Leiterman again, straight up the middle. And Leiterman with some hard running takes it inside the 20, all the way down to the Northern 19, a gain of 5 yards on the play. Call it second and 5 for the Wolves on the Northern 19. And before I forget, once again, I'd like to thank the Central High School Booster Club for sponsoring tonight's game and all the games that we've done so far. Josh, doing an outstanding job behind the scenes, cooking the dogs, selling the corns, popcorn, and dishing out the pop. We'd like to thank them for an outstanding job that they do for every athletic event. Hand off to number 21, Mike Kirchhoff. He is close to a Central first down, probably at the 16-yard line. We'll call it third down and a long one-yard line for the Wolves at the Northern 16-yard line.
They're down in Flint Northern red zone territory here with just under 4 minutes to go left in the game. And Central needs to be really cautious here, not to turn it over again and not to get down right by the end zone and end up with a field goal attempt that they miss. So they really have to motor ahead and punch the ball in.
Blitz by Flint Northern. Kevin Fredericks on the quarterback sneak. Flint Northern, the number 2 ranked defensive team in the Valley. I think Kevin got the first down. He just had to go inside the 15-yard line. First and 10 for the Wolves on the Northern 14-yard line. Right now it's very important for the Central Wolves to take some time off the clock. 3 minutes, 26 seconds and counting for the Wolves on the Northern 14-yard line. Into the game, number 9, Jeff Frazier, coming out number 20, Jay Davis. Kevin Fredericks comes up to the line of scrimmage, first and 10 for the Wolves at the Northern 14-yard line. And number 21, Mike Kirchhoff, off right guard. He has a nice opening. The right side of the offensive line for Bay City Central does a great job opening the hole for Mike Kirchhoff. He takes the ball all the way down to the Northern 6-yard line. A gain of 9 yards on the play. Second and 1 for the Wolves at the Northern 6.
That's an excellent play by the Bay City Central coaching staff. They're lining up Brad Jones and Brad Ackley both at the right side tight end on that last play. And that gives they can crunch down on Flint Northern's defense and get Kirchhoff some carries it where he can move the ball. So we've got 2.5 minutes left to go in this fourth quarter with Central really threatening here. They got a second down and short, and if they pick this up, it'll be first down and goal.
Next week, Bay City Central travels to Flint Southwestern Academy. Again, no cupcake steak for Central on their schedule. Kevin Fredericks, the ball carrier on the quarterback's knee, and he will get the Central first down. First and goal, the goal for the Wolves at the Northern 4-yard line. Official timeout on the field. A Northern player hurt on the play. I can't see his number, Josh.
Number 16.
Number 16. Harrison hurt, but he gets up. An official timeout on the play. But first and goal, the goal for the Wolves at the Northern 4-yard line.
That's right. Bay City Central possibly pick up this first down. They're going to measure here, and with just under 2.5 minutes to go in the ball game, they really need this score right here. I think if they don't score, it's going to be a big advantage for Flint Northern, excuse me, and they'll be able to eat up the clock and at least take a tie. So Central really needs a score here. They haven't been very consistent from this close to the end zone.
Central's had some trouble, Josh, scoring down here. They've been down here three times and have not been able to put the ball in the end zone. So let's see if Lady Luck will change. Coming out here to the left is number 4, Adam Allery. Jay Davis in the wing, Leiterman and Kirchhoff in the backfield. Kevin Fredericks, number 12, calling out the signals for the Wolves. Hand off to number 17, Leiterman. Touchdown, Bay City Central. Chad Leiterman having an outstanding ball game for Bay City Central. And a big, huge touchdown for the Wolves. 1 minute, 55 seconds to go in the ballgame. Central 20 and Flint Northern 14. And Chad Leiterman getting the Bay 3 TV Sports on the Air player of the game tonight, Josh. He's playing great on both sides of the ball. Kevin Fredericks in to kick the extra point. They've had some trouble here. The kick is up. The kick is off to the right. Penalty flag on the play. So hold on for a second. But Josh, Chad Leiterman doing an outstanding job tonight.
That's right. Every year about playoff time, the teams realize that they can only have 50 players on their squad, no more than 50 players. And sometimes I remember last year when Central only had 45 players, they decided to pull up five sophomores, and Chad Leiterman was one of those players that they decided to pull up because of his experience. He was only a sophomore, but he's got tons of playing experience and tons of stamina as well as smarts and being able to move the ball. So he's one of the guys they brought up, and he's being very consistent after Todd Gall's absence. He'll be very explosive next year.
Replay coming up on the touchdown to number 17, Chad Leiterman. Outstanding job on the left side of the offensive line. Brad Ackley's happy. Chad Leiterman's happy. Touchdown Bay City Central. Great camera work there by our crew and our technician in the truck, Mike. Outstanding job giving the Wolves a 20-14 lead. And there was a penalty on the play. Illegal procedure, dead ball foul, moves them back 5 yards. Kevin Fredericks in to kick the extra point. Kevin struggling tonight for the extra point. The extra point kick is up. The extra point is just off to the right. And a big extra point miss for the Wolves. But making the score, Bay City Central 20, Flint Northern 14. And hold on to your hats here, folks. We're going to go down to the wire. Minute 55, 20-14 Central. And the shades of last week, Josh, but just not as much time on the clock right now for the Northern Vikings as there was for the Traverse City Trojans last week. But we don't want to bring anything up. We don't want to think about that and jinx everybody on the Central squad.
That's right. Central should be able to lock down their defense here after this kickoff. And they should be able to hold on, but we've seen weirder things in high school football, especially on this basically Central Elmer Engel field. And, you know, Flint Northern has an explosive team. We've seen 40-yard passes tonight, and we've seen Beard run. He's got a 10-flat 100 when he runs, so he can get out in a hurry in, you know, 6 seconds, and he can be gone. So we'll look for the Bay City Central defense to tighten up and the Flint Northern squad to be very explosive here in this last 2 minutes.
They're able to kick off for the Wolves. A little squib kick, ground ball, picked up by the Northern Vikings, and tackled immediately by number 33, Jared Wadluski. Also there, Jay Davis. Both of those young men are having an outstanding game on the defensive side of the ball. So right now, Coach Gene Rademacher, defensive coordinator for the Central Wolves, his defensive squad is going to have to play some serious defense for the next minute, 53 seconds. Coming out onto the field, Coach Rademacher got the erasable whiteboard. He's got his defensive squad around him. Also out there talking to the coach there for a second was head coach Morley Frazier. Once again, my name is Mike Wisdella, along with Josh Smith. We're bringing the game from Elmer Engel Stadium. Bay 3 TV Sports on the Air. Also like to thank the Bay City Booster Club for sponsoring tonight's game. Also the Bay City Public Schools, all our technicians, our camera people, excellent crowd. I hope you're enjoying the game as much as Josh and I. Josh, once again, thanks again. It's a pleasure doing the games with you this year. And looking forward, we'll be back up here in 2 weeks when Bay City Central takes on a very strong Arthur Hill squad. So check Channel 3 on your cable TV and check for the time and the replay of all the games for Bay City Central. And we're having a great time seeing some great Saginaw Valley League action.
That's right, Mike. You know, we talk a lot about special teams and a lot about momentum and things. And the Bay City Central team has got 6 points and the clock in their favor. But one of the big things for Flint Northern is that Brent Vrabel, with a really short kick, they kept the ball out of the hands of the quick backs. But this gives Flint Northern very good field position.
Hand off to number 6, Ida Beard. He rumbles off the left side, picks up 7 yards on the play. First to meet at number 17, Chad Leiterman. And also in on the play, number 34, Brett Vrabel. Also number 11, Danny Maciejewski into the ball game. Gain of 7 yards on the play, 2nd and 3, ball on the northern 49-yard line. Out here to the right, number 40, Derek Lee, sharps barking out the signal for the Northern Vikings. Hands off to Beard off the left side, and a nice game for a first down into Wolves territory. Tackle on the play, number 53, Jack Mao. Jay Davis also over there once again. Chad Leiterman having an outstanding game on both sides of the football. 1 minute, 19 seconds to go in our ball game and county. Flint Northern on the move here at Elmer Ingalls Stadium. Central 20, Flint Northern 14.
That's right, and Flint Northern is moving the ball extremely well. They've got 2 plays, and there's a nice tackle for a loss by Bay City Central. 2 plays and a first down, that last play is a blunder, but when you've got a minute and 20 seconds, Flint Northern knows what they need to do to move the ball up and score, and they just moved into Central High territory, so I look for a long pass play, and if they hook up with it, it could be very costly to the Central defense.
Jack Bow with a great defensive play for the Wolves, a loss on the play, making it 2nd down and 11 for the Northern Vikings on the Bay City Central 47-yard line. Timeout on the field, Flint Northern. We've got 1 minute to go in our ball game. 20-14 for Bay City Central. They are in the lead. And I'd like to also mention that a former Bay City Central player was named Defensive Player of the Week at Ferris State, Jim Lyman. Defensive Player of the Week for his game against Wayne State last week. And so we'd like to say congratulations to Jim. Over at Ferris State, he has an outstanding player at Central. That seems like he's doing the job at Ferris, Josh.
That's right. This this Bay City Central team really spawns a lot of good players. Like I said, in the last 4 or 5 years, they've had a lot of good people come through here. A lot of people go on to college. It's a program.
Sparks back to pass. Nice defensive play by number 1, Chris Woodrow. He had number 40 out there, Lee. Open, and a great defensive play by number 1, Chris Whitbrook, to get his hand up in the passing lane, knock the ball down. 3rd down and 11 for the Northern Vikings on the 47-yard line of Bay City Central. Took 3 ticks off the clock, 57 seconds to go in the ball game. 2014, 6-point lead for Central Wolves. And once again, like we said, Josh, it's going to come down. They're going to have to go for it if they don't make the first down. Sparks, double slot out to the left. Number 85, intercepted by number 12, Kevin Fredericks. He comes down the left-hand side of the field, and he is run out of bounds by number 9 for the Vikings, Nicholas Sparks. But Kevin Fredericks with a big interception to hopefully seal the win for the Bay City Central Wolves. The pass was intended for number 85, Stocker. Kevin Fredericks stepped up, intercepted the ball, brought the ball all the way back to the northern 40-yard line. And, I think the coaching staff at Bay City Central right now is breathing a huge sigh of relief First and 10 for the Wolves at the Northern 40-yard line.
That's right. The Northern Vikings were on the move there. And Bay City Central's defense was decent. You know, Chris Whitrow broke up that nice pass play between Sparks and Derek Lee. But now with that interception by Kevin Fredericks, that brings them down towards the 42nd mark. And with the lead, six-point lead, they're looking to run the clock down.
Nice job by Kevin Fredericks. We do have a penalty on the play. I think Flint Northern had too many people on the field, so that'll move the Central Wolves 5 yards closer. It'll take them into the 35-yard line, just what Central was looking for, 43 seconds to go in the game. It'll be first and 5 for the Wolves at the Northern 35-yard line. And once again, thanks to everybody on the crew, all our camera, Mike Pruill inside the truck, executive producer Dave Rogers just stepped into the booth with us. That's going to take the ball all the way down to the 25-yard line. First and 10 for the Wolves at the Northern 25-yard line, just inside the 25-yard line. 43 ticks to go, Josh, and it looks like Central is going to come out of this Saginaw Valley League action 5-1 and go to Flint Southwestern next week with a 5-1 record, but a huge ball game down there also next week. It doesn't get any easier for the Wolves.
That's right. This Central team was looking a little bit itchy coming into this game. They weren't sure about Flint Northern. I know they'd done their homework, but Flint, you can never do too much homework for this Flint Northern team. They have a good team every year. They do a lot for, you know, against the other team. And Central, they beat Central consistently in the past and had a powerhouse team in the past. So Central came in, and they had to really tighten up the nuts and bolts to get away from that Flint Northern team. So they're really fairly lucky to come out of this game a big winner.
Kevin Fredericks takes a knee, and there is a late hit on the play by number 51 for the Northern Vikings, Eddie Hodo. And I'll tell you what, the Northern or the Central faithful did not like that call. This game is pretty much over. 12 seconds to go in the game. 20-14. Dead ball foul. Personal foul against Northern. And Kevin always got to take a knee. And Eddie came in just a little bit late and tried to rough Kevin up. But Kevin jumped right up. But Central will come out of this with a 20-14 win. Once again, we'd like to thank our camera people, Terry Langston, John Walker, Kevin Kopis, Karsten Krabby, and Mike Pruill, our technician down in the truck, producer, and also Dave Rogers, our executive producer. Bay 3 TV, Sports on the Air, exciting Saginaw Valley League action. We'll be back in 2 weeks. Saginaw Arthur Hill will be here at Elmer Engel Stadium. And it doesn't get any easier, Josh. Next week, Flint Southwestern, and that's all there is. There isn't any more. The fans storm the field celebrating Bay City Central's 20-14 win over the Flint Northern Vikings. And again, Josh, an outstanding game right down to the wire. And Central comes out of it 5-1. And like we said, we're speaking to play in Traverse City. And we're big Traverse City fans tonight, Josh, because we'd like to see the Trojans beat Muskegon.
That's right. The Traverse City Trojans really knocked Central back on their heels last week with that big non-Valley win. But Central really came back to beat Flint Northern tonight, and they really showed that they have confidence in what they're doing, and they're not, you know, slouches at all. They really know what they're doing on the football field. And like I said all through the game, you know, it's the coaches, coaches, coaches. They do a lot for the Bay City Central organization, and they know what decision to make, when to make them. You saw it all through the football game. You saw Chad Leiterman come in where Todd Gall was hurt. You saw the use of a lot of different players in a lot of different positions. Brad Jones playing on offense, as well as Jay Davis getting a good offensive look, and Chad Leiterman. So you see a lot of different players getting in on a lot of different things, and that's what Bay City Central fans like to see. They like to see this Central team come out, utilize a lot of players, and utilize a lot of the ball, you know, score the touchdowns, score the field goals, do what they need to do to win a ball game.
Well, they're telling us to once again wrap it up in the truck, Josh, and we hear them down there, so we're going to wrap it up real quick. Once again, the final score from here at Bay City Central's Elmer Engel Stadium is Bay City Central 20 and the Flint Northern Vikings 14. Thanks to the Bay City Booster Club. Thanks to all the cameramen. Thanks to our producers. Thanks to you, Josh. We'll be back in 2 weeks. So if you want to see some exciting, exciting football, come on out to Elmer Engel Stadium with a final score. Bay City Central 20 and the Flint Northern Vikings 14. Good night, everybody. We'll see you next time. Arthur Hill, Bay City Central.